But we had a pretty good time last week. As opposed to the week before, which was horrific. Tomorrow night, we'll see you there. And I'll see you in hell.
Fuck you all.
With the temporary return of JB to monetize this, credit to Always Nerdy.
You left.
Yep. Always Nerdy, thank you. Everybody else, thank you. Good night.
What the fuck happened to my radio show?
We had a pretty good time. And ladies and gentlemen, as opposed to the week
JD
before,
Venom,
horrific, has taken the king's crown.
I told you that piece of shit wouldn't retain tonight. Fucking lot lizard fuck.
Oh my god, lot lizard fuck. Well, after that nude picture, it was going to make it hard for him, no doubt.
Hey,
enjoy the STDs, you pussy faggot.
Ugh. Oh.
Someone should take that picture and make a Tinder profile.
That's not a bad idea.
I'm coming for you.
Not tonight.
It'd be more like a Grindr profile.
Oh, even better.
Yep. I mean Leah did elect against it, so looks like I'm going to be jerking off tonight.
Here comes Linda McMahon! Hell yeah!
Beetle Maniac? Beetle Maniac?
Oh boy.
Space.
What's going on, everybody? What is what's up, everybody? Sorry that I sound like shit, but my voice is fucked up. And I had a really weird day today, so yeah.
Yeah, you have to fill me in. I've stayed off Twitter all day, so.
Oh, well, it's
I've wanted to be surprised, and I don't know the ratings yet.
Really?
I stayed off of Twitter, Facebook. I yelled at Spaz not to tell me. I have the article in front of me. It says AEW wins. I know that much, but I didn't see the numbers yet. So I've been patiently waiting for out of nowhere to happen so I could see if our predictions were correct.
Oh, I can't wait to read this to you.
I mean,
where do you want to start?
I want to know the ratings. I am eagerly anticipating. I have spent all day avoiding social media so I could be surprised.
Well, our worst nightmare came true.
Really? It was off by, like, what, 1,000?
995,000.
Oh, no. Oh, damn.
And I thought the worst case was 998, but it was 995.
5,000 off. Couldn't they blow somebody at Nielsen to get that other 5? Come on. Oh, no, honestly, that's disappointing.
Well,
I guess it's... I'm scrolling down now. NXT 659. Wow. Huge difference there.
Yeah, NXT got raped. I mean, let's...
340,000 viewer difference. NXT got... That's half of their program.
Yeah, and you know, number... this was like
more
their biggest...
Half.
This was one of their biggest... This was like their biggest rating in a year.
Yeah, AEW was number 2 in cable for the night with a 0.45... Wow, that's huge. I think the week before they drew 0.36.
Yeah, they destroyed, dude. This is a crazy amount of, like, a crazy good number for AEW, even though, like, in my opinion.
That was the week before, 2 weeks ago. So the week before it was a 0.42. That's great to pull a 0.45. They were number 2 in all of cable.
That's wild.
That is insane.
Dude, it's a wild number, but in my opinion, like, this is our huge win. Like, let's make no mistake. It was a huge win.
It's a great win for AEW, no doubt, but it is disappointing to be that short away from that million number. Not that it really matters in hindsight. I mean, they still broke some, you know,
no, I'm disappointed.
Decent barriers here. But
I'm disappointed because Sting drew 30,000 to 60,000 people, and I thought he would draw 300,000.
I thought there would be more, but I'm curious of the breakdown. I want to see how it did, like what the highest segment was, and... I'm going to look into that shortly, but wow, that's really disappointing. I mean, we knew last night. You even gave us the option if we wanted to change our prediction, and I had a feeling, you know, jokingly as we said that it would be a few off, but I didn't think it would come to fruition necessarily. I that is disappointing. I was hoping they hit that million even.
Yeah, it's too bad, man. Yeah, I had a rough day today, so I'm sorry about my voice. I think I know why my voice got fucked up for a very real, like a specific reason. The throw up fucked my voice up.
Oh, you were throwing up today too?
Have you ever, I mean, you know about this. Have you ever, like, you feel okay, and then after you throw up, your whole voice goes raw?
Yes, that's I was trying to talk earlier to do the second part of the spaz thing, and it took me forever. I felt so bad, but I was vomiting beforehand. It just burns your vocal cords, and I lost my voice for a little while. So,
Yeah, so
it's brutal.
Yeah, I'm like, Jake knows all about this, I think. You know, I in fact I probably need to go suck on some kind of lollipop or something in a minute. But it was the weirdest thing. I was out working my second job, and I was driving everywhere today, and it was a nightmare of a mess. So nothing was working out. I about used up more gas than I think I made. I think it was going bad anyway. And you know that I've been sick and or whatever with this weird stuff. And one of the biggest things is all the congestion in my face and nose and neck, and something's wrong with my throat, it feels like. And what was it, November 16th that I lost my voice? So I lost my voice on November 16th. Then 10 days later, I kind of got like re-sick again a little bit. But this sickness has been like this weird, naggy, like cold or something. It's not even that bad, but yet it's still around, so it's pain in the ass. So anyway, I'm driving and
Super Chat.
And we go to Super Chat.
Party.
Hey, what was your thoughts on Sting's debut in AEW and Impact as a whole this week?
Well, we're definitely going to get to that. We're definitely going to get to that, Aaron.
Yeah, there's a lot of news for that.
Yeah, let me tell my personal stupid story first so we can get everybody in here. I'm also delaying to get everybody in here. We got 300 people now. More people are getting the alerts. Aaron Crafty, 123. Aaron, thank you so much for the Super Chat, man, and keeping the channel alive and dropping a couple of dollars, brother. Thank you, man. There's also a couple other donos that I got to play. I think we're like messed up here for some reason. I don't know why, but I'll figure it out. We'll figure it. We'll fix it. Somebody dropped one earlier as the stream started, too. Who the hell was it?
Soundwave?
No, it was Big Matt.
Oh, okay.
I'll get Soundwaves, but Big Matt dropped one. It wasn't a Super Chat, I don't think, Soundwaves. I hope it wasn't. Yeah, we'll talk about that, too, Big Matt. That's an important thing to talk about. Anyway, whatever. Skip all the other stuff. Who cares? Whatever. I'm working this job, and it sucked anyway. And I was literally up the street from my house. And I'd been getting that. You know when you get the nasally drip in the back of your throat? You know what I'm talking about?
Oh, yeah.
And you know,
it gets like stuck, clogged.
Yeah, like when you start going like, and you're like trying to, and when you like cough it up and you cough up phlegm, like shots of phlegm, you know, that nasty, like almost like you're shooting spider webs. So
yeah,
that's going on, right? That's going on. And I don't have any hot coffee or anything in my car, nothing. So, and it's doing that thing where it's like, this is going to be gross. I'm just going to tell you right now, this is nasty what I'm about to tell you. And it does, and I become, and I'm like, you know what? This is not going to come out of my nose. This, and other than, by the way, I don't even feel sick at all. Like I'm dry. I'm like, yo, what's up? I'm good. I'm not sick. It's just congestion weird. It's been for weeks. And so I'm like, I'm going to hack this up, whatever this is, because it's stuck in the back of my throat and it's bothering the shit out of me. I'm just going to hack this up. And as I kind of coughed at it, I pulled out all these napkins in my hand in case, just to see if case a loogie came out, you know, because that's gross. And instead of a loogie coming out, just I feel this giant slurge come down my throat as I blow it all out.
Oh, lovely.
And it won't leave. It won't separate in the back of my throat, and it covers my throat. And I'm like, and I can't breathe, really. It's like cutting off my fucking air. So then I have to make weird noises to get air. And then I'm coughing more and I can feel it. And I'm telling you, and after a few seconds I became panicked. And I was like, "Oh," and then it triggered my gag reflex, and I immediately swung the door open on the car, pulled over. This is like four streets away from my house. And I start throwing up everywhere. Just bleh, and I'm only throwing up because of the gag reflex.
Yeah, it makes you choke.
Yeah, I'm not throwing up because I'm sick. I'm throwing up because of gag reflex. And I can literally feel the acid or whatever from the throw up, like really, you know, I'm already sensitive back there, right? All the rawness from what I did to my voice from screaming the last couple weeks. And so now that hurts. And now I'm throwing up and I'm like, okay, it's got to be coming out, right? Because I'm throwing up. Like, so this phlegm must have come up. No, it's still there. And I begin throwing up again. And then I realized this is so thick and huge. Thick and huge. probably like Zeus's cock, rest in peace. And I realized that this isn't coming out of my throat, and it's really bothering the hell out of me. And I'm really panicking. It's weird. I've never felt anything like this in my life. So I realize in an instant that I've got to reach into my mouth and pull out this snot, phlegm thing. And I reach, and this is all instinct, right? Because like normally you would be like, I'm not going to do that. You know, I'm going to wait till I get home, or I'm going to do something. But it was all panic and instinct that, oh my God, you got to reach into your throat. And I'm in like a neighborhood in broad daylight. There's like a cop over here and like all this construction going on. And then like some guy outside, and like the door's open. I'm throwing up in the street. And I then reach into my own mouth and grab this giant thing. And it's giant. It's not like a little hanging thing. It's a giant thing. And I pull it out. And as I'm pulling it, it's still attached. And I can feel all this weird sensation running through my throat, neck, and up into my face and eyeballs and all around, almost like I'm pulling it and it's all coming through my fucking, and just, and this big thing comes out, and then it rips off, and I throw it on the ground like an alien just came. I gave birth to fucking aliens. And I throw it on the ground, and I can still feel a little tickle in the back of my throat, but most of it's gone. And I'm like, ooh, and then I throw up again because that was gross. And like, I'm kind of grossed out. So now I'm looking at this puddle on the ground of shit. The phlegm looks kind of white, though, you know, mostly white and a little yellowy, but it's mostly white. And I'm like, well, good. It's not like green, like fully green or something, because that would mean like a severe infection or something. And I'm like, I can't believe that just happened to me. Like, I can't even believe that that's real. Like, that might, maybe people deal with this every day or like every week or every once in a while. I don't know. But me, I've never had this happen before in my life. And I was terrified. And so I went home. And
I'm not laughing at you, but the chat is hilarious. I'm sorry. if you practice more, Joe, you wouldn't be gagging so much.
I wish I could read the chat right now. I have it paused on Matt's donation so I can talk about it.
Ed's View said 50 Shades of Cronin. So
now, Monica did beg me for a photo of this thing.
I just saw it, yeah.
Okay,
I saw the side of the car and the napkin photo.
So on Twitter, I did send her what it kind of looked like. I found it on Google, and I was like, this is close to what it looked like, but the thing I found still isn't big enough. What came out of me is bigger. But what happened was later on in the house, I did have it happen a little bit more, and I only got about, not even close to what really came out of me, but I had like a mini version of what happened. And I showed that to Monica and said, well, there you go, you nasty bitch. Here you go. And it looked like the biggest jizz stain. Like, it looked like all the jizz that I ever had in my life come out at once. And anyway, that being said, I washed my face and was gargling stuff. I went home, cleaned my mouth, and then I decided not to go back to work. Because I thought that was kind of...
Yeah, I would feel like total shit after that, too. I wouldn't want to go anywhere after.
Yeah, you know, especially since I was doing delivery stuff. The side of my car has puke all over it. The neighbors just were like, probably like, what is this? This guy stops and throws up and then they see me throwing up, and then they see me like reaching into my mouth and like pulling out dude, if anybody has a street cam, if any of the neighbors, I almost want to fucking go on Facebook and post out, hey, did anybody
get this on their Ring?
Yeah. Can you check your Ring camera? Because I would love to have this for my show. Like, I have a podcast on YouTube, and if I could just get me throwing up in the street and then pulling this gigantic baby out of my mouth, this cum shot out of my mouth, could you please, I wish I could say I'd pay them, but I clearly can't pay anybody since I'm delivering shit throughout the day. But I would love to.
Sorry, I didn't mean to cut you off there. I would die if you know, as you're delivering something, you go ahead and you get to the door and then that happened.
Oh, no, that would have been, I would have ran.
Whenever you're delivering, like, you know, food or item, you know, whatever, maybe you go ahead and just look at the delivery person as they're snotting all over your porch.
Oh, my God, dude. I'm so glad that didn't happen. Thank God it was, I was on my way home. I was almost home.
Thankfully, but this sounds super disgusting, but I literally use sandwich baggies to vomit into now because I'm out of those anemic bags, whatever the hell they are from the hospital. But if I literally got up to vomit throughout the night as much as I do lying in bed,
yeah,
I would go ahead and have to put a, you know, pillow and blanket in the bathroom. So I've mastered just vomiting into bags, and it's disgusting, but it works because I'd have to get up every 15 minutes.
Well, I'm going to build you something if that's the case. Like, I'm talking about, like, I'm serious. I'm talking about, like, a tube and what's, you know, what are they, when you put the oil in the car, the
thing. Like a funnel?
Yeah, funnel. Yeah, put a big funnel. Big
get
funnel.
Get a series of tubes. Yeah.
Big funnel.
Send it off.
Big funnel near the bed, right on the ground. The tube goes down, up and around, and then down into a bucket. I mean, and then, you know, because then you can clean that out. And it gets away from you. The baggies are a pain in the ass. You know, that's a pain in the ass. I guess
they are a pain in the ass, but at least they seal at the end, thankfully.
That's a good point. Big Ziploc bag, like a big one.
No, smaller ones. This way you can just put them in another one and they seal. Double seal, no leak. That's the way to do it. Freezer
I mean,
bag.
We really are training to be in NASA here, if you haven't noticed. Thank you to everybody who's listening tonight. You listened to that disgusting story.
Until you had waking up and you're all covered in stomach acid, you don't have a worry, okay?
Yeah, so that puking, I'm a lot more fragile than Jake, you know? Jake does this all the time.
No, it sucks because it ruins your whole day. It just, you're wrecked after it because your back's sore, your sides are sore, you know, because you're pulling muscles and your throat hurts. It wrecks you.
I thought I was going to get that, but luckily I didn't get the muscle stuff, which I thought might happen because that does happen, obviously. But I haven't gotten that. But what did happen is it really fried my voice. It really did. Like, it did a number on my voice. And I said, wow, I have, like, no voice. Like, I was trying to yell at the kids. I'm like, can't do it. Can't yell at the kids. And I don't know what to do. I had to go upstairs, grab something out of one of their hands, and spike it on the ground in front of them. Because I wasn't able to say stop or go in your room, or you're going to be in trouble for this. I basically said, please stop. I have no voice to yell and to tell you guys whatever. And they didn't listen. And so I took it and I spiked it, like, into the wall, like a lot, like hot, like very hard.
I can picture the scenario. You know, you can't yell and you're like, God damn it. You're so frustrated, but you want them to stop.
And then my daughter looked at me like, how could you do that? And I said, you're not listening, and I can't speak. Get in your room. And I look like a psycho. And she went in a room and cried.
Those whisper anger moments, when you do have those, the very rare few times, you know, like, I remember Danny throwing a tantrum. She was always so good, so it was a very rarity, you know, for this to happen. But she explodes, and it's one of those days, and I remember not being able to talk, and she's like, why are you smiling? Just holding her hand, leaving the store. It's like, because I'm going to kill you in the car, you know, one of those moments. But
I'm going to dump my throw-up baggie on your head. How about that? Okay, so listen. We'll get to Big Matt's donation in a second, Big Matt. But before we get to that, let's just go back to this again. 995,000 viewers. Top number one best show in a year for AEW. Amazing. I think that it's a little shitty. I'm sorry. I'm not looking at this glass half empty either. I am looking at it glass half full, but it just is, oh, man, damn it, that means, like, it really means about 30 to 60,000 people tuned in because of Sting. That's it. 30, you told people, guess who's coming to tell everybody why he's in AEW? And 30 to 60,000 people stopped in. Oh, Cora's in the chat. Cora, what's up? Oh, my God, I'm sorry that you were messaging me on Patreon today, but I was at my second job, and I was... so busy with everything and having a problem that I just never got back to you. I'll get back to you later. And yeah, so like, what do you think about that? I think it's a slight disappointment that, man, that's all Sting drew. Because
it is a slight disappointment. And when you go from year to year, I mean, last year, both shows, surprisingly enough, tied at 718,000, I believe it was.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, they had a tie. So this year, when you compare scores, it shows that NXT has gone down gradually and AEW has continued to go up. I mean, that's how it at least looks year to year. It is a bit disappointing as they had such a stacked show, but as we were watching it in real time, and keep in mind that it wasn't live, thankfully it wasn't spoiled, but it wasn't live, and lo and behold, you did feel a little bit of disappointment watching it. So I could see some people tuning out and not staying, because that 995 is the average. So that means they definitely broke a million several times. I don't see a segment-by-segment rating breakdown yet. Probably tomorrow that'll be released. I've looked just about everywhere I could so far and haven't seen it. If anybody does have that, please let me know on Twitter or in the chat. But yeah, it is a disappointment. Still great for them to do so great in the 18 to, you know, that specific demo that they're always after. 0.45 is great, up from a 0.42. And the big story here is this is NXT after their big pay-per-view. I mean, that's even more telling.
Yeah, it's a mess.
This is after their War Games pay-per-view. They had, you know, a really good showing the other night, and I thought they would have a pretty solid lead-in, but that was not the case. So, really surprising for NXT.
You know, if Sting wasn't in AEW, then basically AEW would have done 900K twice, or at least once.
If Sting wasn't there, I think Sting is still pulling a decent amount for them, because if you look before the winter show, when they had 913, they had 710 the week before that. So Sting definitely gave them, I mean, we can't give a 200,000, you know, viewer increase all to Sting. He certainly had an influence on it, but a lot of that was also because people wanted to see the championship match with Moxley and Omega. So that was also the increase. Plus, it was a advertised weekly special. You know, the winter is coming was a theme special.
And yeah, because they were drawing 900K before Sting came out, and he was a surprise, right?
For their average, yeah, that's what I'm saying. So it's still, but I'm saying if you look from the week before, there's still that 200,000 increase. So Sting has some effect, but as you said, it's not as much as what we thought it would be.
Yeah, I was hoping for more, but
I was hoping for more as well, and I'm surprised even the Shaq influence didn't bring them a little bit more. Just because that was focused on as well with the start of the NBA, and that leads to an interesting thing next week. NXT is unopposed; they get to start at 8 o'clock, and then we will go into NBA on TNT that starts at 7:30. So you have the Bucks versus the Celtics that night. And
wait, the NBA is already starting up again?
Yeah. So,
wow. I'll tell you, how lazy are the Celtics, man? They should still be beating the Lakers. Instead, they're tied for championships. What the fuck, Lakers?
And what sucks is that's their holiday show. That's the 23rd. So, you know, like you said, we'll have a late night, you know, getting ready to wrap presents the next night. But their holiday bash that Tony Khan announced isn't going to start till that Bucks and Celtics game is over. So that's 10:30.
Well, the Bucks suck. We'll finish them off real quick. It'll be over.
Celtics will just wipe the floor with them. It'll be over. But you figure on average, you're looking at 10:30 probably being the earliest you'll see Dynamite start. And it stinks that that's, you know, a chance for them to lose quite a bit of ratings there, because who knows how many people will stay up.
You're right.
We'll see.
Now, if history tells us anything, it's that people do commit to AEW. So, I mean, never have we seen anything like that, maybe. But, you know, I would guess that AEW will still be above the 800,000 line. You know, and that's a pretty good thing for now, they're going to go live. So no matter what happens to the NBA, they're going to be ready to just go live with their show?
No, that one's taped.
Wait, this week?
No, the 23rd, the week after.
Oh, I thought we were talking about this week.
No, no, not this upcoming week, the week after.
Oh, okay, okay, okay. All right.
The 23rd. They're going to be live this coming week, and then they're taping the next day, the 23rd, Holiday Bash.
Okay.
Yeah, because that's when the NBA starts back up. They're going to have, they actually say in the article here, odds are the game won't be over till 10:30, which will create a late time start for Dynamite. NXT is unopposed. They have no issue. It will be interesting to see what NXT does, because are people going to tune into NXT just because there's nothing else to watch?
Probably. You know? I bet you they'll get a better number, yeah. So
we'll see how NXT fares. That's my...
Yeah, NXT's looking at a 680, 700 fucking rating, probably.
Hopefully they do better than that if they're unopposed.
I'll say 720 right now. I mean, and we got 2 weeks to go, so you know I got to remember that. But
I think they'll be smart about it, and knowing that they're unimposed, they'll try and book something big. So I'll say 750. But
they should book that they're gonna roast Cody Rhodes' family. That's what they should book. Tell you what, Triple
H, the way to go.
Triple H comes out and says that he's you know, he was a big fan of Dusty. Obviously, love him, rest in peace, all this stuff, but. You know, he's been buried once before, and in a couple of weeks, I'm Triple H, and I'm going to shoot on him, and I'm going to bury him again. And then stare into the camera, and then you know, Triple H buries the Dream and buries all the wrestling families in wrestling, and he's going to do a 10-minute shoot interview on all these families, like the Von Erichs, and he's going to call the Von Erichs heroin addicts. Like, are you kidding me, dude? They do a million. Triple H comes out and says, I'm calling out the heroin addict Von Erichs and the Rhodes family, every single one of them. Dustin, Goldust, used to molest people in the locker room. and he says that and goes, I'll see you next week where I'm going to tell it all. Like, oh my God, bro, they do a million. I'm better than Triple H at booking this shit. But just saying. And
that
nobody,
because everyone loves drama. So
and AEW ain't on. AEW ain't on. You, no, you ain't on, brother. I'm gonna tell it all.
What if they pulled an old Bush off, and they spoiled something that happens on AEW?
Well, that'd be lame. I don't think they'd do that.
Since it's taped, no.
I'm talking
just
about
just a reversal of roles.
I'm talking about going after dead family members, Jake.
Like, I know, but they won't do that. But I'm saying I think it would be great if they really had Triple H act like this matters and we're getting our ass beat, so I'm going to start attacking you and taking this seriously. Triple H, fuck yeah. Sign me up. Well, we're not going to get it, though.
Well, speaking
they don't pay any attention to anything at all. I kind of made that note before because, I mean, think about it. When Tony messaged me, you wouldn't see Vince message anyone about, you know, any type of discrepancy. And certain, so they care about those things on that side.
That's a great point. Yeah. Imagine when you think about it, it's even crazier. Every time you remind me that this happened, it kind of blows my mind. Like, Tony Khan DM'd you to set the record straight on something.
Yeah, absolutely.
That's
crazy. And but, you know, Vince a billionaire. Wouldn't, so obviously... They care about their image and things like that online. Rightfully so. You should, because
right.
Social media is important nowadays. So Triple H, NXT, WWE, they haven't taken shots, and they're losing.
Right.
AEW has laid out a ton of shots, especially the Impact stuff they did the other day, you know, with calling Dean Ambrose, you know, by that name and going ahead and all the stuff about Stanford. And, you know, they're smart about it, but they're doing it in a way that was, I figured that was good from a heel side of things. That was less of a petty thing, and it was a good way to do it. But you haven't heard anything from NXT. It'd be great to see Triple H, you know, reclaim the war. You know,
right.
let's see it take
get
this
dirty.
Seriously. But
I mean,
they don't
dirty.
Have that mindset.
No, they don't. They wouldn't. I don't think they would do that. But they should get dirty. Joe Cronin says
they
get
should,
dirty.
Though.
You hear that, Triple H? I'm telling you to get dirty. I know, man. Joe Cronin knows. All right, let me go to these donations real quick, and then we got more to talk about. There's a lot of stuff here. There's something, speaking of Impact, we're going to talk about.
Think about the Raw only drew a 0.51. They drew a 0.45.
Mm-hmm.
You know, they're not that far off as far as the demographic goes, and that's what they all pay attention to. Then WWE should be worried that your main show is, you know, closely getting, you know, encroached on. Basically,
right.
AEW's ratings are building. They're not that far off.
Yeah, they're getting there. They'll get there too if it keeps going. Big Matt says you were number six on WrestleMania's video today.
Yeah, about fans that, or wrestlers that were upset with fans, something along that line.
Yeah, the funny thing about it, though, is nobody ever covers the story the right way or even go. I mean, I get it, though. It's a quick video about fans or whatever. And it's like, dude, first of all, listen, I don't care.
It made you sound like you guys were upset you didn't get a picture taken.
Yeah.
I listened to it at the beginning of the stream, and it's so off.
I mean, you'd think, listen, I do like WrestleMania. I like WrestleMania a lot. I think they're great. But could you do a, I mean, and this is not just them. They painted the narrative in the video, which is fine because it's the easy narrative to go with. And if you watch the video, you kind of think that that's going on. They sort of paint the narrative that me and JD were fans. We were fans of Ryback and we wanted a picture with him. And then he just got angry at us and called us out.
Yeah.
So why would a wrestler just get angry at us for like wanting a picture? And then he even called us, I think he called us YouTube celebrities or something like that, or something. He called us something like stars or something.
Influencer, and, something like that, yeah.
Yeah, influencer stars or something. And it was like, but why? So like, clearly there's a bunch of story missing here, right? Like, he missed the part of, we asked Ryback to be on my show. Ryback declined, asked for $2,000. Then I called that out and made fun of him, saying he wanted chocolate bars. Ryback wanted $1,000,000. Ryback wanted 5 Rolls Royces. Ryback wanted golden nuggets and a purse. And then Ryback made a video being like, Joe Cronin's a fucking liar and I don't know who the fuck he is and what the fuck. And then we get into this little war on social media. And then, actually, at the time, I was just starting to work with a former co-host of mine, and he called in doing a Ryback impression, and it was funny as fuck. And then, you know, I had been doing a Ryback impression, but my Ryback impression was not that good, and my buddies was killing it. And so we did this thing, and then basically...
Yeah, we did a whole mock interview.
Yeah, and basically, you were there, yeah. Basically, Ryback heard it, and he heard all this shit that we were saying. But he got all weird. And then, so then when I saw him at WrestleCon, I said, well, JD's with me. And I say to JD, I'm like, dude, I'm going to go up to Ryback. He's like, are you fucking serious? He's right over there. He goes, Ryback's right there. Let's say, we could say hi. I'm like, dude, I'm going to go up to Ryback and I'm going to fucking set the record straight. Fuck all this bullshit about fucking what we can say and what we can't say. And, you know, he's mad at us. Fuck that. I'm just going to go up to him. I don't give a fuck. JD goes, what if Ryback, what if he fucking tries to fight you or whatever? And I'm like, I don't know, bro. I don't know, dude. I don't know, whatever the fuck. You think he's really going to do that?
Then I'd let him hit me so you could sue the shit out of him.
Yeah,
right?
I mean, that's kind of what I thought. Like, well, I mean, I don't know, in front of everybody, you know, I don't know. And I'm like, well,
we'll edit the video. We'll take out the part of you saying, hit me, pussy.
Yeah, I didn't do anything. So
No, you didn't.
We go up to
Ryback.
He made
you sound like a drunk that was there and a wife beater, all pathetic-like.
Well, Ryback's a big... Listen, Ryback's a big liar. Everybody knows that. Even the WrestleMania guy made fun of him. He was like, yeah, maybe Ryback deserves it. And it was like, even he... That's the funniest thing, is the WrestleMania guy knew. So Big Matt, yeah. So basically... When we got up to him, as we were getting ready to walk away from Ryback, fucking stupid JD. JD goes, can I get a picture? Can we get a picture? And he goes, no, absolutely not, or something like that. Now, I didn't want a picture.
Yeah, way to read the room. But so, it would have been good, like you said, to have, because it would have shown that, like, you guys, he's above it, he's
yeah,
cool.
It was a good idea.
Criticism.
It was kind of a good idea from JD. But I kind of was cringed about it because I was like, dude, I don't want a fucking picture with him. What the fuck? So, or like, I don't want to ask, why would you ask him for a picture? You know, he wouldn't even really, if he had said, listen, guys, it's all fucking bullshit. Why don't you listen? I'll sign some shit for you and let's hang out. Then it would have been cool if he offered it. But JD offered like, oh, I get a picture. Now, Ryback should have done that because he would have looked cool and he would have made us look like assholes. Like, hey, let's take a picture. Look how cool I am. I'm Ryback. I'll still forgive fucking dorks like you guys. You know, but this is a war over the YouTube stuff. I mean, dude, at the time, my podcast got more views than Ryback's. you know? So this was good for him, but instead he shits on me. I'm telling him I'm sorry. Listen, I'll just take all the blame. It's all my fault. Me and my producer had a problem. We misunderstood. You know, hope everything's okay. I do comedy on my show. That's all I try to do. You know, it's nothing serious. I've stuck up for you when WWE shit on you when you were injured. You know, I know who you are, and I don't think you're some goofy fuck, you know, completely. And he just kind of went, all right, whatever. And then the next day, he buried me on his podcast, buried us. Like, he after telling me that I needed to be positive, he then shit on us. So, you know, and then, you know, then there's a few of those back and forths that went on the podcast world. But the WrestleLamia guys just made it sound like we were crazy fans who wanted shit signed by Ryback. And I thought that was kind of hilarious because it was just like, that's so not the way it went down, but it was great that they painted it that way because, I mean, listen, if you're putting together a quick video about the angriest fan interactions, you know, you're not going to sit there doing a case study on fucking, you know, the Ryback situation. So let's look at the Raw video real quick, right? Because this is fun to do. Now, most of you have seen this a million times. We don't need to go over this a million times. But, dude, to this day, people still come up to me and go, aren't you the loser that wanted Ryback to take a picture with you or whatever? And I'm like, dude, that was JD. I don't know why, but JD gets away with everything. These people always get away with everything. People like JD. New Yorkers. Something about New Yorkers. They get away with everything. That people are like, aren't you the guy that wanted a picture with Ryback and you filmed Ryback? And I'm like, okay, I didn't film him. JD did. I went up to him. I didn't care if JD was filming, not filming. I don't care if he wasn't filming, was filming. I don't care if there was a Hollywood production going on. I didn't care about the camera. I was going up to Ryback as a man to say, let's cut this shit, and I respect you. And I'm just a fucking wrestling podcast guy, and I'm doing comedy shit. Don't take it seriously, and whatever the fuck. And here's what I'm doing. Let me explain to you. That's what I want to do. That's all I was doing. I was being the man. JD's the one that videoed it. JD's the one that asked for a picture. and it wasn't me. But yet, I've had his fans attack me and say, like, oh, you wanted a picture of Ryback, blah, blah. Must have been you that orchestrated that whole thing. I'm like, what the fuck are you talking about? Anyway, whatever. People are retarded. And it was really just both me and JD. Look at this guy staring at me, typical with a fucking New York Yankees hat. I hope he's dead.
No, but you understand, though, like, so.
Yeah. I'm just kidding. I don't know who that is. I hope he's okay.
Considering you called me a pussy.
I like how he says, like, let me bring back, like, he's trying to get angry.
Considering you called me a pussy, let me fucking, you see Stu Bennett in the background? Stu, Wade Barrett, he hates listening to me go on rants every fucking day.
Publicly, you've never.
Look at Pat Buck. Remember Pat Buck? Didn't he get beat up on Raw the other night?
Yeah, he got his ass beat.
So Pat Buck with his red hair.
In McInport.
Pat Buck took time off from wrestling dead, dying grandpas and taking their money to be on Raw last night and get beat up. And Wade Barrett is now staring at Ryback like, are we really going to fucking do this again? You know, like, he's really like, are we really, here we go again. There goes Ryan. There goes Ryan fucking roundhead fucking craterhead getting upset again at some fucking fan.
Maybe you don't know me. You're publicly talking shit to me and then you do an impersonation on your show.
I didn't do the impersonation.
You put out, no, but it's you. You make the decision to do it. Don't blame it on your fucking producer. It's fucking, it's disrespectful on so many levels. You don't know me and how fucking hard I've worked for this. And you, a guy that, you're a fucking fan.
And I wanted to see you do.
You've never done this. And there's shit people like you that do this shit that give me a bad image. Ask anybody else.
You give me a bad image.
That's the best part.
Shit like you, you give me a bad image. I don't give myself a bad image. You give me a bad image, you fuck. Look at my chin. My chin is like a fucking cone. A vagina cone.
Don't bring, like, he's, and like, now he's bringing fucking Stu Bennett into it, who's trying to sign an autograph for somebody.
The fuck eats me alive. Guys like
eats me alive, I'll kill you.
When you fucking do that, why? I would never in a million years go and disrespect another human being like that.
I would never in a million years go and disrespect another human like that. Jake, how many tweets and threats and rants including,
oh my God,
including this guy in the background, Pat Buck, who now works for WWE. Didn't you threaten to like make sure you get him fired from his job?
Yeah. Multiple times.
Ryback, I don't care. I'll say this till my dying breath. You, Ryan Ryback Reeves, are a piece of shit. Scumbag asshole. You are a bad person, or at least a fake person. I don't know which one. Maybe just a fake person. I would never disrespect somebody in a million years. Your tweets at people alone contradict this statement 100 times. You fucking liar, fucking fake.
All that fake positivity. Look where it gets them. You wrestling's in a down period. I charge people $9. Yes. But think about in the sense of like there was a resurgence since he was let go from WWE. There was a big indie presence that happened and all these different federations that popped up. And he could have been working much more and he got a few little bookings and then nothing. And he's not hired now. There's got to be a reason for it because All Friends Wrestling, as it said, you know, they work together with Ryback. You figure there would be some connection. He could have gotten hired there. Excuse me.
Right.
Didn't happen. So time and time again, there's a reason why you don't see him as a big name booked anywhere. You hear a bunch of stories, you know, and you don't know. Everything's alleged. Everything's, you know, nothing's always proven most times. I mean, our interactions, obviously, we can tell from our side. But with him, I've heard so many negative things time and time again. If it's all true, okay. I always take things with a grain of salt, but it seems that way.
I can tell you.
It comes from that many sources, though, Joe. That many people I've spoken to. Meet and greets, backstage wrestlers, people work, and they just don't care for him.
And he's blaming Pat, and he blames Pat Buck and all these other people now for him not getting booked. It's him. There's no doubt about it. I'm the biggest, like, I'll forgive you person ever. There have been people that have done crazy shit to me that I've forgiven, right? And because I'd want to be forgiven too, especially if I'm just joking. I can tell you right now, this guy is a horrible, weird person. Now, I think he's joking mostly or playing a gimmick or whatever, or messing around. I think maybe in real life, he's way better. I think he is. I think I'm a better person in real life, and I think Ryback's a better person in real life. But, you know, you don't say, I'm going to get Pat Buck fired from his job. I'm going to get you fired from your job. But you were just friends with him. Now, he's still friends with Stu Bennett, Wade Barrett, I guess. But everybody else, he's burnt. I don't know. I've offered to come on his show under an alias. I even offered under an alias to come on his show and apologize to him under the alias. Or record it off air, and he can play it if he wants, or whatever, not play it. I just have a conversation with him to explain everything as a man. And all these things. I've offered all kinds of things. Come on my show, I'll promote your show. And this is back when his show had like no viewers. And I was like, dude, I'll promote the shit out of you if you want. You know, it's not about, he thinks it's about like a shock thing. I'm like, I don't give a fuck about that. I just want you to know it's not that serious. But he's insane. And he threatens people on Twitter. He goes after people on Twitter. He hopes people dies on Twitter. And, you know, he's going to get Pat Buck fired, and he's going to get all these other people in trouble, and he hates people, and he's going to attack them. And but sign up for my $9.99 a month so I can teach you how to be a positive person. The fuck are you talking about?
Yeah, he contradicts himself far off.
You know what it is he's trying to figure out how to be a positive person. That's what it is.
Yeah, you got to show and be entertaining in your own way. Yeah. Don't fucking pull me into that fucking world.
Don't pull me into that world, yet he pulls everyone into his show's world when he shits on them. See, I think now Ryback understands. Have you never heard of Howard Stern? Have you never heard of, like, Jim Cornette? Have you never heard of anybody else who does stuff entertaining and podcasting? It's like you're really taking it that personally. And it wasn't even that bad. It was just somebody else did a Ryback impression. I mean, yes, I did one too, but mine was stupid and I barely did it. It's the other one that set him off and these other things. And it's like, but you could have been on the show. And you still could be on the show. You could just be on the show and, like, just make us look stupid. Be like, yeah, these guys, I thought they were losers, you know. This guy kind of looks like a loser, but then put me in a headlock and squeeze my head a little bit and, like, scare me a little bit. You know, go ahead. Why not?
But you do. It's on you. So don't say it.
You know, if he had whispered to me in private, I'll be on your show, but I'm not going to look like a bitch. I'm going to have to smack you around. Like, I would have signed a waiver. I'd sign a waiver. I'd put him over. Like, smack me in the face like that reporter back in the day who got slapped and his eardrum exploded. But don't explode my eardrum, please. But slap me in the face and I'll fall over, and then you can tell me say you're sorry, bitch. Say I'm a bitch and I'm sorry. I would have even done that for him to make him, to put him over, because I care about wrestling and I care about Ryback looking good, and he's got indie bookings and stuff. And then it would be like Ryback bitches out Joe Cronin and makes him look like a bitch and stuff. And I would have done it. I'd do that for him if he whispered that in private to me. And I would have never told anybody it was a work. I would have said, dude, he fucking snapped. And after that, he said, you know, sorry, we're it's over with. I'll come on your show now. No, now that you see, now that you're fucking humbled. And I
know you're a very forgiving person, because I ate your pet chinchilla after I raped it to death, and you forgave me, so.
Right. And listen,
I know for a fact you're forgiving.
That was my son's favorite. That was my son's favorite animal, and I just offered it up to you. Now maybe I should have gone for my dog and not his little dog, but in the end, sure, whatever. But anyway, we've beaten this thing to death for years. And the bottom line is, here you can hear JD in a minute go like, "Can I get a picture?"
No, no, I got you.
Position to influence people.
Stu Bennett's like, shoot me.
Don't fucking be the shithead that makes the world better, a fucking worse place. Make it fucking better. And you have that opportunity, yet you do it, and fucking, you bash me in this net. Oh, I'm joking. You've never met me. You don't know me.
Exactly. I've never met you, you fucking idiot. That's why it's a joke and it's stupid. Come on.
Moron.
Why doesn't he get it?
Yeah, Hector's right, though. The scariest thing out of all of this is that, you know, you're so nostalgic and sad seeing the video. No one's wearing a mask. People are not distanced.
Somebody put a Ryback.
It's so awkward.
Put a mask on Ryback. What are you doing, Ryback? Don't you know about COVID?
You don't. Not at all. So I appreciate you apologizing, but you've already been calling me a pussy. People don't know that. You've never met me. You don't know me. So
no, people know. People know Joe Cronin isn't going to beat up Ryback, probably. Don't worry. You know what I mean? Like, come on.
It just, you being disrespectful, and there's a certain level you don't cross, and you did, and you just don't say, oh, my producer fucking did it. Just be
if he cut promos like this all the time, man, I'd be his, this guy, this was a great promo. When he starts looking away and talking shit like that and looking back at me, that was some stone cold shit right there. Here's where I'm explaining, like, I made videos about your injuries and how WWE misused you, and, like, we've, you know, I know about your career. That's what I said there. Now, see, I'm right in his face, too, talking to him, like a man. I'm not a pussy. I would have avoided him I would have been like, oh, let's stay away from the Ryback table. I hope Ryback doesn't see me. I went right up to Ryback's face. I didn't go up to Ryback looking for a fucking photo opportunity. I went up to Ryback face to face. To talk to him as a person. I don't give a shit that JD was filming.
Ryback just declined a picture. I was willing to give him money.
Ryback was willing to give him a picture. I was willing to give Ryback money in a picture. I was going to give Ryback a picture.
Fucking, what a fucking weirdo, JD. Like,
I need to decline the picture.
I would say that legit, that's how much he hates me.
He knew of the imitation Ryback on Joe's show without even Joe mentioning anything to him. So either someone he knows listens, or he listens himself to Joe's shows. And then his guy was like, you filming this? You filming this? That's what you guys seen.
Good security, Ryback. Get some new security. Get some new security. JD filmed the whole fucking thing. Your guy asked him if he was filming. JD just said, no. So anyway, WrestleMania put this out today. So shout out to WrestleMania. We spent way too much time on this. But then, obviously, instead of mentioning like this whole beef in the real war, they just go, two fans went up to Ryback and they wanted photos. But
incredibly hypocritical, and it could land you in a verbal confrontation. This was seen when controversial social media and YouTube personalities JD from NY.
Okay, I guess we're social media and YouTube personalities.
Joe Cronin approached Ryback at a public wrestling convention. Ryback instantly knew who the two men were and told him how their comments towards him have impacted.
Ryback had no idea who JD was.
Ryback then asked him, why are you asking me for a photo after all you do is sit behind your keyboard and bash me on a daily basis? Kind of hard not to do, to be honest, as Ryback has asked for it on a number of occasions.
See, the guy even, he knew that, though. He knew that Ryback sucks. That's the best part about this.
As if, but we didn't sit behind a keyboard bashing him. You know, we referenced him three times ever, and we got mad.
Kind of hard not to do, to be honest, as Ryback.
Also, Ryback was bashing me during that whole time.
Ryback has asked for it on a number of occasions, but the two social media stars didn't know how to react, and in the end, they didn't get the picture they wanted, as Ryback outright refused the request. Number 7.
Now listen, if you guys want, go check out WrestleMania's video, 10 WWE wrestlers angry at rude fans in public. We got called rude, we're lumped into rude fans. Can you believe that? We're lumped into rude fans.
That's why I said with the title, like, you know, it fits for some of the other videos, but with you guys, you're not rude at all.
I'm
glad.
I'm just I'm happy we made the list. Listen, you got to title it like that. You got it because that gets way more clicks than.
Yeah, that's the bait that draws you in.
You know, I mean, 10, then you'd have to say 10 awkward engagements with fans or whatever. But yeah, it was more of like two YouTube podcast hosts get in a fight with Ryback. I don't know. I guess we insulted him. He insulted us. Fuck him. But he's the, you know, wrestlers are the star. You know, we're not the star. So that's the important thing is we're not the star. The wrestler is the star. You know, it was nice that he called us social media stars, though. But I do love WrestleMania. Very honored to make some kind of list with them because that's funny as fuck. And I enjoy their videos a lot. So shout out to them. Great stuff. Watch the whole video. It's a good video. It's 10 minutes. It's perfect top 10. You're going to love it. Let's play a donation now. We've been babbling on long enough about this dumb shit from years ago.
Shit bum.
Mega cheap plug. NXT review is up now.
Woo!
Tomorrow night after SmackDown, Guapo and I start breaking down the AEW tag division. And next Friday, me and Jake continue to break down the NXT women's division. Stay sexy, everyone.
Thank you, Spaz Phoenix.
Yeah, part two we recorded today, and it's a great listen, talking about the women in NXT, you know, the second part of this continuation, so it's really good.
$5 shit bum from Spaz Phoenix and the Spaz Phoenix podcast. Check out Spaz Phoenix and his podcast. It's really good. He really breaks everything down,
Dunkachino?
Like minute by
don't
minute.
Don't mind if I do.
Oh, shit.
What's my name?
Dunkachino.
It's a whole new game.
Dunkachino.
You want creamy goodness? I'm your friend. Say hello to my chocolate blend.
Nope. Rest in peace to entertainment legend. From Zeus in the 80s to Debo in the 90s to present day. Also, never forget when Carlton turned into a G with him on Fresh Prince of Bel-Air. What up, Jake, Big Daddy Cool, DeMarco, and Jono Corona Cronin?
Yeah, it doesn't look like Corona, I don't think, but you never know, Botch Club. Botch Club, thank you. What's going on, man? And yes,
yeah,
we really haven't gotten to say it, but rest in peace to Zeus. Tommy, is it Leister?
Lister, I thought. Might be Leister.
I always called him Tommy. I've met him twice, and I call him Mr. President. And I'm not even kidding about that. When I saw him live, I really did call him Zeus, though. I said, I don't know what this guy's name is. I know that he was in Friday. I love him in Friday. I love him in Fifth Element.
Yep.
And I love him, obviously, in the movie with Hogan, No Holds Barred.
Yep.
Those are the three big movies that I was like, this guy was a staple in our childhoods. At some point, he was in all these movies that we liked.
He was in The Dark Knight briefly. He was in Next Friday, obviously, with the other Fridays.
Mm-hmm. But Fifth Element, to me, dude, he was the first black president.
Yes, yeah, and he killed it in that role. That's a standout.
Oh, my God.
But obviously, you know, his two wrestling runs that he had. And it's really upsetting. Apparently, it was natural causes. He passed away in his home. The L.A. County Sheriff Department said friends and business associates of his became worried Thursday, so today, when they hadn't heard from him since Wednesday night. So they performed a welfare check around 3 in the afternoon.
A wellness check. I know he's black, Jake, but come on, dude. Come on. Wellness check.
When they performed the welfare check, they made their way into the apartment, and unfortunately, he was deceased. So he was, yeah, Jackie Brown. Mm-hmm. You know, there was so many great roles, and usually he was one of the standouts, you know, featured in those. Like, he was always remembered. That's the thing. Like, even if he didn't have a key role, like, whatever he did do in the movie, it was a standout. So
the
when you think of Fifth Element, he didn't have the biggest role, but he's one of the first things I think of.
That was a pretty big part in that movie. I mean, he was in the movie from beginning to end as the president. They introduced him pretty early.
I'm saying, like, it wasn't the main role, is my point.
Now, it's just, what a choice, man. The director to be like, it was kind of weird. I mean, when you think about it, it was a little bizarre. Like, we're going to make sure we pick a black guy because we want to show how it's the future and this is just the norm, you know, because we hadn't had a black president yet in America. And so it was like, this is the norm. Obviously, there's tons of diversity. Everything's whatever. No, he's the president. But he's kind of like, although he's trying to be presidential, and he is, he's very presidential, you know, but it's just a weird choice, himself. Like, it wasn't a, you know, it's not a... not Samuel L. Jackson, but like not like a Morgan Freeman, right? Morgan Freeman playing the president is greetings, Americans. Like, it's Morgan Freeman. Like, you would think he would be the president or something, and it's like, no, Zeus is the president, and that is hilarious. And he was
in Little Nicky, Santa's Sleigh. I forgot he was in that briefly. Goldberg as Killer Santa.
Let's not bury the dead here. Come on. Like, let's go with the good movies. Let's relax.
Well, even still, those are funny, good comedic roles.
No, it's true. I mean, I met him at WrestleCon 4 or 5 years ago now, and I got to find that photo, but he was so nice, man. Like, so nice. I referenced something that he talked about in an interview once about the set of Friday. And I said, man, based on what you said, your relationship with, who the fuck was it? Was it Ice Cube? It might've been Ice Cube. Somebody.
Yeah, Ice Cube is in that.
I said something like, the relationship you guys and some other guy too, I forget the guy's name. I go, you guys must have gold being recorded off air. And he knew exactly what I was talking about. He was like, and it's like, you should have recorded that shit. Like, get somebody to record that next time. Like I was trying to tell him on this is a podcast, you know, if you guys are on set. But I don't know. It was just a fun time. I told him about Zeus. I was just going through everything. I'm like, dude, I'm a big wrestling guy. And one of my favorite movies ever is Fifth Element. One of my favorite movies all time is Fifth Element. So to see this guy when I was young and in No Holds Barred, and then to see him in a movie a little bit later on in my early teens that was one of my favorite movies of all time, like, he was a big star to me. Like, I mean, you know, a lot of people say, well, B actor, C actor, or whatever, but it's like, that guy, I was really fucking, that was one of the best guys I met the whole night, like, of everybody.
Oh, I bet. He always sounded and seemed very, very approachable and personable and very considerate. Yeah, any interview that I've seen, and I saw some things pop up, like with TMZ and stuff like that, he always just seemed to take his time out to be nice to people. You know, I forgot he was in Barbed Wire. You know, people said Austin Powers, Beverly Hills Cop 2. He's just got such a huge discography of movies, such a wide array. You know, yeah. Horror, comedy, action, drama, romance, there, you know, it's all over the place.
I want to see him in a porn. I hope that comes out eventually now that he's passed away. Rest in peace, though, to Tommy. Just really sad because he's a sweet guy, is from what I always could tell. Very nice guy. I love this guy. So, fuck 2020 again. Taking a nice man like this who was working hard still. All the Comic Cons, all the things that he did. And that sucks. You know, I mean, maybe he had a heart error and he had to, like, you know, I heard Bill Burr say the other day on a podcast with Kevin Bacon, he said, you know, oh, yeah, I've got to make sure I book some extra comedy stand-up things. You know, I still got to pay for the mortgage, you know? And I said, what the fuck are you talking about? Bill Burr has to pay for the mortgage? Bill Burr has F is for Family on Netflix. He's in multiple movies, including Star Wars.
Maybe he just didn't want to pay all of it off at once.
He has a million stand-up specials.
Yeah, it's shocking to hear that he didn't, you know, pay it all off, but maybe he...
No, but I don't know if he means that, though. Like, I literally wrote it on the podcast today on YouTube. I wrote on his fucking channel, I said,
Wait a second. You're telling me, Bill Burr, you're worried about your mortgage? I mean, I'm worried about my mortgage. I'm kind of concerned here, you know, to be honest. But you're telling me you're worried about your mortgage? You have a Netflix series and a bunch of stand-up specials and a podcast that does triple the views that mine does, and or cars, I don't know, way more than mine does. And all these other things, and you're Hollywood, and you're in these movies, and all these other things. And you're telling me, Bill Burr, that, well, you know, I had to go out because I got to pay the, you know, got to pay the mortgage still, you know. So wherever I can go, drive-ins and whatever. And I'm like, bullshit. That's, it's just got to be that you have an ego and you want to go do your material. There, you can't really have to go out and do stand-up in a fucking garage, you know. Yeah, a lot of comedians do have to do that. Like, you know, even... you know, Derek that I had on my show recently, Derek Richards, comedian Derek Richards, he probably has to do this. Dave Landau and Anthony, I talked to them the other day. In fact, I still have to upload that interview with Dave Landau. I held off on it.
Yeah.
But Dave Landau, you know, he's got to fucking go out and work still to pay off some stuff. Bill Burr's net worth, according to fucking everything, is $12 million.
Well, like Too Sweet said, maybe it's mortgages, maybe it's plural, and he's got multiple things, and that's why he,
I can't,
instead of
it,
paying all of them off, or you have a mortgage on one, you own the other.
Maybe.
Never know.
I guess you never
know.
That's
not uncommon, like you have a mortgage on your vacation home and your main home, you just, it's paid off. And
I mean, if I was Bill Burr, I would go full like Joe Rogan and just create my own studio, and I would just pump out more podcasts. I'd just be like, all right. You know, I mean, but now if he had said, well, I got to go do the stand-up stuff because I'm always creating material and there's no way to find out if it works or not without being in front of a live crowd. So I have to get in front of a live crowd to create this material, and I'm an artist and I want to create material, and that's it. So I'm going out to do this stuff. But instead he went with the, I need to pay the mortgage. And I just felt like that doesn't seem right. You don't need to pay the mortgage. I mean, unless Bill Burr's buying crack, you know, I don't know. Anyway, whatever. The bottom line is JD's a pussy, and Ryback could have beat him up, and I'm glad he didn't. Thank God he didn't.
Here we go.
Alex Oley with a donation of $5. What's up, Alex?
Oh, no!
Wrestle Kingdom 15 under a month away. Jay White versus Naito double titles biggest wrestling show post-pandemic 30,000 fans Tokyo Dome. You or Jake watching?
Alex, I think I'm actually going to watch. I'm going to go out of my way to do as much as I can to watch this because we're going to get fans.
And was it last year or the year before that you had stayed up and then fell asleep
while
watching?
3 years ago.
3 years ago.
It was actually 3 years ago, yeah.
I remember because there was nothing I could do to wake you. It was just like, yep, that's it.
Funny.
But, yeah, it's definitely something we're looking forward to. As much as I haven't followed New Japan like I once did, I still like to watch the Wrestle Kingdoms and the big shows.
Hey Joe and Jake, it's me again. I'm a huge Sting Mark, my favorite wrestler of all time, so to me the four words, see you around kid, gave me goosebumps. I'm excited to see Sting treated the way WWE should have. Epic debut.
Looking forward to what he does, says Stowe Code Steve Boston. Wow, haven't heard that name in a long time. Holy shit, man. Thanks for the donation. Wow, that's an OG right there.
Here comes the
money. Oh, no.
Money talks.
Here comes the money.
Come on. Here comes Shane McMahon.
What do you think about Shaq and his weird for cereal expression to Brandy throwing water on him? Lamau seeing Sting say he signed with her, you did give me goosebumps toe after 18 years.
Yeah, I mean, cue the Curb Your Enthusiasm. Boom, 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 boom. That's Shaq ruined the whole. Shaq was terrible. I'll tell you. The more I watched it again the other day. Brandi Rhodes is trying her damnedest to put this over and be mad and whatever else. And Shaquille,
she has a right to be mad, but she also seemed a bit too heelish at times. It was kind
of
odd.
She was a little over nasty to him instead of being like she should have played it like that. She's kind of angry, but she's got to be wicked diplomatic because Shaq, and they're trying to get him to be on the show, and he's Shaq, and she's giving him this respect, like. But instead, she was still kind of like full scorned or whatever. So she's a little too far. And then he's just a troll. He's like, I don't know what I did. Yeah, I don't know. Oh, by the way, work on your punching because you suck or whatever. Excuse me?
Yeah, he tells her to take notes from Jade.
And then so Shaquille O'Neal goes from cool, calm daddy to heel, I guess, troll.
Well, kind of like a coward too at times, almost, because he was like, "Oh, all that stuff I said about Cody was just a joke." Like now it's time to nut up or shut up, and you're shutting up. Basically,
everybody knows I play on Twitter or whatever. Which I like that because I was like, "Well, that's what I'm like on Twitter." You know what I mean? Like I fuck with people.
I get it. I just wasn't crazy about the way they did it.
And then at the very end of it, when she throws the water in his face, he should have been angry. When she threw the water in his face, he should have been like.
Yeah, he basically kind of gave a funny.
Like he should have thrown the fucking
goofy look and
he should have taken the lavalier mic off like this and fucking spiked it at the ground. And he should have looked fucking pissed off. And then he should have gotten up. And then he should have fucking thrown the fucking chair back and said.
He at least should have started yelling at Tony and been like, "This is what you had me here for." You know, that kind of idea.
I would have
been pissed.
Maybe I won't work for your company, you stupid bitch. Like, and then they blank out, bitch.
I would have just said, you know, how is the executives at TNT going to feel about this? Because he works for TNT as well,
with
basketball stuff for the NBA.
That's a great point.
So if they're going to do it, play up that angle a little bit and be like, you know, if you don't want Cody and Shaq to fight, then make Shaq untouchable because of the network and you're covered for a while.
Make Shaq be like, "I'm sick of getting the emails, you know. We got to talk about AEW. We got to talk about the wrestling show. We got to put over the wrestling show. You guys all riding off our heels." They even put a wrestling ring in the ESPN studio. Remember that? You put the TNT, whatever the fuck. You put the wrestling ring in the studio. All ready to play around. It's always about promoting your little product that doesn't, you know, we're the NBA, you know, and you're riding our coattails and you're just like a little you're annoying little dog, you know. And then, you know, when she threw the water in his face, you know, have that anger and that I'm mad that we have to keep putting you over in your terms. And, you know, you're riding our coattails. We don't need you. You need us. And that sort of thing would be interesting. And that look on his face, though, where he just goes like, it's like, I don't know what to make of that segment, man. It was all over the place from serious to then troll, then heel, then comedy. And it was like, what the fuck are you doing? I mean, I appreciate Shaquille O'Neal's range, but it was like...
Just don't have Shaq. I agree with Treads. I don't care for him being there at all. I don't think it's adding to the program. I don't think it's going to bring in this viewership they think. I don't think there's that interest in a match with Shaq like they're thinking
either.
Why not just bring Shaq in?
Why not just bring Shaq in as the manager of Jade?
That would have worked and had him just, instead of trying to build, he's the giant and we're going to have a feud, wait, we're not because I'm afraid and I'm just trolling. It's awkward. That's why I said I really didn't care for that, but Brandy was okay, yet again, surprisingly.
Yeah, I like Brandy. I can't
She was a little
it.
Too heel, you know, she laid it on a bit thick, but all in all, I liked her aspect of it.
I like
especially
Brandy,
when
though.
Usually she's very cringy, so.
Usually I am hard on Brandy and I'm hard for Brandy. But,
no doubt,
she's very beautiful.
Absolutely.
But no, this was the best Brandy has been doing. Her stuff with Jade and this gold.
Yeah, she's two for two perfect. Right now with these. Even the backstage with three for three when she got attacked with her arm, she sold that well.
Yep. And she was the other thing that she did do well. I will give Brandy credit again for something else. She was great on heel commentary. Like so, she did that well too. So. Good when Brandy gets like real pissed off or like ghetto-ish, I love her. Like I don't know what it is.
Yeah, when she acts
super
real.
Super chat party.
Bry guy dropping in a super chat party. What's up, Bry guy? Thank you, man.
Just so you know, Joe, the Soundwave 92, his $20 donation didn't get played.
Yeah, right. You're right. I don't know what the fuck's going on with that.
I think because it came in as we were starting. So
you're right. I think because it came in as we were starting and because I was on Evil Spectrum still because I played Cyberpunk earlier today, I had Evil Spectrum set up for the donation thing. So
there you go.
The JCS
How did you like
stuff.
Cyberpunk? I saw on Twitter you weren't crazy about it, but...
No, I'm not. I don't
it's
like...
not for you.
I'm done with these. I hate the role-playing things. I've come to the conclusion I just can't do the, oh, let's watch a story for 10 hours. Okay, now do activity 5, and now go back to story. Now do activity 6.
Yeah, you prefer more of the instant gratification.
Or just playing. I just want to play a game. I don't want to watch a movie.
Yeah, you don't want to sit back and not be interacting.
Yeah.
I get that.
Plus, it's full of glitches and shit. Cyber junk. Cyber junk.
I heard it's really bad on the older console.
Oh, it's bad. Looks like shit. Yeah.
Joe, go to the fucking doctor and get some health insurance. You can't keep living your life without health insurance. It is so important and worth the money most of the time. Your health is important and you should see a doctor when you can. Fuck Deba, bro.
Ra 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 ru. Thanks for the donation, man. It's $1,300 a month, so that's not
going to
happen.
Problem. It's not feasible, but you do need to go to the doctor. I'm telling you.
I might go,
You should go
tomorrow. I may go. if it keeps hurting, like it's going away. I think so. I think we're gonna be all right. But yeah, if my throat continues to hurt or like my neck still on this side starts to keep hurting, another 2 days. If I don't improve fully in the next 2 days, I'm gonna go into the Minute Clinic. Brian Alex 21, thanks for the donation because it is only $100 to go into the Minute Clinic. But it's kind of getting hot out here with COVID, so I've just stayed inside.
Oh, yeah. A little bit of the bubbly.
That's it. That's
Want
it.
Some bubbly? Look at this stuff. Oh, oh, a little bit of the bubbly.
That's it.
I need to offer an apology for the disgusting words I said yesterday. I promise you it will never happen again. Jake, let me do your brown eye. I will turn it black. Shout out to Gorilla Strong. I love you, bro, and Ned's View. Cheers, guys.
What's up? Casey is raw.
Casey wants me to be black now? My God.
Randy Viper says throat cancer. Yeah, imagine if I had throat cancer, dude. Just kill me at that point. Like, just like Bobby Heenan, right? Bobby Heenan was the worst.
Oh.
Oh.
Oh. Oh.
Oh.
Was gonna shoot the breeze tonight and just talk ratings, which by the way, smart on you, Jake, for muting group chat to avoid spoilers. But hearing Tiny Lister has died just when this god-awful year was getting near its end. Fuck, man.
Yeah, it's really upsetting to hear that.
F it all.
Because he's still young. 65 to me is still young.
Oh, you know? Shit. I thought he was 62.
Maybe 62. I thought it was 65, but either or, you know, it's still in his 60s, early 60s. He's young.
Oh, God. Imagine if I had throat cancer. I just can't get over it. Soundwave, thanks for the 2020, man.
Go to the doctor before you stress yourself into getting cancer.
No, I mean, I go all the time, and then they're just like, you fucking idiot. Except for remember the last time I went, and they were like, nah, there's nothing wrong. And I'm like, I'm telling you, something's wrong with my ear. Like, something's wrong with my head and my ear. And the guy goes, you're fine. Then I went home. Then it hurt more the next day. Then I went in. Then the guy goes, yeah, you got an ear infection.
I'm like, see?
I was here the other day.
Yeah. Well,
no, but it
that's
is.
That's the problem.
Like,
sometimes it takes a little bit to worsen so it can be seen, but you can feel it
right here, just sore and sore over here and here. But yeah, it wouldn't that be nice? Bobby the Brain Heenan gets throat cancer. Like that guy, like he couldn't get foot cancer, skin cancer, anything else would have been nice. Anything else would have been nice for Bobby Heenan, you know, any kind of cancer, you know, fucking anything. But no, they get, like, God gave Bobby the Brain Heenan throat fucking cancer. The guy with the voice, that's all he does. Throat cancer.
Talk about irony.
I mean, what a bunch of bullshit. Like that guy he should have lost his legs or something. Like he loses his legs and arms, but he is in a wheelchair, and at least to this day he could still be sitting down doing a fucking podcast. You know, we'd have Bobby Heenan telling stories till the end of time. The Bobby Heenan and Conrad podcast. Conrad Thompson and Bobby Heenan, they'd be tearing it up right now. But no, you had to give him throat cancer, you piece of shit. Like, life. So yeah, it would figure if Joe Cronin got throat cancer, wouldn't it? You know?
I offered you to gargle semen. I told you that helps.
Oh, my God.
A little bit of salt. Gets everything going just the right way. It's like a vitamin.
Well, we know if my throat still is bothering me, and the, like, it's external too. It's out here that it feels sore. If it still feels sore in the next couple of days, I'm going to go in. Because that's weird. It should start getting better. Like, it should...
Speaking of a weird set of occurrence, and with I noticed the chat. I wasn't going to bring this up next, but the chat was talking about it. So we'll give them what they want. Snoop Dogg is going
to
be on night two of AEW's New Year's show that they have going on. And WWE, we heard immediately after, and I'm talking 2 hours after that was announced, I heard that WWE was pretty viciously upset with Snoop. I wonder if this is going to have any effect on Sasha. Probably not, but it makes you wonder. You know, when they get spiteful at family members for doing things, it usually trickles down. As we saw with Lana, you know, originally this was a punishment and it kind of turned into a story angle because they think they're smart. But any event, we also saw today that the Undertaker and Snoop Dogg merchandise was pulled from the shop, but it wasn't actually pulled. It was only available until December 6th. I don't think a lot of people realized that it was just a limited thing that was happening. So WWE didn't pull it down for this reason. It's just the sale was over. But now the listing is down entirely. So people kind of ran with that and said, oh, see, he's on AEW. They took it down. Now it just says page not found. But I did hear that several, you know, people in the back are, and this is all alleged, take it with a grain of salt, but from reading the rumors and whatnot, several sites have reported people are upset in the back with Snoop Dogg. So I wonder, what do you think? Is this going to have an effect on anything going forward with Sasha at all, or do you think it just won't matter?
Take that stupid Snoop Dogg song away from Sasha and just give us
I miss her original Sasha. Theme.
Yeah, give her back her real theme, for God's sake. God damn, is that Sasha thing suck dick. Like, that's that Snoop Dogg theme suck dick. Like, really?
And you figure, you know, he's been in WWE for quite a while in the sense of he's been featured every now and again for years. So this is a slight bit of, don't not a betrayal, but
yeah.
What's my feels name? That way.
Dunkachino.
It's a whole new game.
Dunkachino.
You want creamy goodness? I'm your friend. Say hello to my chocolate blend.
Here's my plug donation.
Yes.
Whoever complains I donate to Joe Cronin and Jake Big Daddy Cool DeMarco is a certified fart mark. That being said, Joe, please share my latest post must watch. Trust me. I'm sure I'll donate again tonight. Joe, check your Insta DM now.
I'll check out the Instagram, baby. Thank you, Botch Club. Much appreciated. Botch
Club. And the funny thing is, too, Joe, on WWE's merch site.
That's it. That's
want
it.
Some bubbly? Look at this stuff. Oh, a little bit of the bubbly.
That's it.
JD from New York. 206, it's time for Off the Script. Big Show and Ryback, Roman and Strowman, get off my fucking TV, save me the misery. All you fucking goons, grab a cold beer, the man of the hour is finally here. JD from New York.
JD from New York. Remember when JB used to do the intros to me and JD's stuff?
Yes. He made quite a few introductions, yeah.
He just made... JB made my intro and JD's intros. Unbelievable.
If you search for Snoop Dogg on the merch site, it says, I'm sorry, did you mean dong?
Oh, my God.
That's hilarious.
Well, and here's the thing. I heard Snoop Dogg is starting a wrestling or a boxing company.
Yeah, he's supposedly getting involved in the world of boxing now.
And he's going to be the commentator.
Fan reaction, so.
And he's going to be the commentator. That's what I read.
If that's true, I can believe it. He had a really great reception to the Tyson fight.
I think that's a mistake, because I think then it's like he's going to make it all about him, and he's going to be like overdoing it now. And I think what made him great was that he was like third man in with funny shit. But if he is like the main commentator, I don't know how that will work. So I'm worried that he's going to oversaturate himself. Apparently him and some other guy with money are creating a fight night thing, and it's going to be on Saturday nights, and it'll be like $30, and it's going to be a big thing, apparently. It's Snoop Dogg and some other guy, and they're starting their own fighting company or whatever. That's what I heard, and I heard he's going to be the commentator.
Hey, we'll see how it works, but...
I mean, he was phenomenal the other night.
He was great. At first, it was distracting. Then, as it went on, it became less jarring. You got used to it, and then I loved it, so...
Right.
But it did take a little bit to get used to.
Yeah, it did. It took a little while to get used to be honest.
One of the big things I wanted to bring up is WrestleMania. People are going nuts at this point in time with all of the alleged booking ideas. One of the things that spiraled this into a, you know, wrestling rumor frenzy was WrestleVotes tweeting that the tentative plans for WrestleMania, and as they always put on this account, nothing is close to official, you know, so they can get away with saying whatever, but Reigns versus Goldberg, Edge versus Orton, and an interesting twist, McIntyre versus Keith Lee versus Lesnar. A lot of variables in play, especially the attendance factor. Now, we had already started to discuss the other day that their original plan was Roman versus The Rock. That's what they wanted in the worst way. But The Rock has multiple, basically, scheduling conflicts and things that are keeping him from having that kind of availability. But one of his biggest offsets and putoffs is that The Rock didn't want to do it not in front of fans. Now, it's also being said, according to Wrestling News, that Vince McMahon wanted The Rock in L.A. They wanted to have that extra media attention being in L.A. And it would be easier to get mainstream coverage in L.A. But since they're doing WrestleMania 37 in Florida, Vince really doesn't want to have that type of lessened media buzz that he would generate with The Rock versus Roman. So his backup, of course, comes to fucking Goldberg.
Yeah.
And Vince likes having Goldberg in his pocket because he is a draw. I don't know why, but he is. I don't get it. I don't see it. I've never been crazy about Goldberg. Like, I get into the hype sometimes and stuff, but it was always showcased, you know, prominently. 2 minutes and under was his sweet spot. Anything longer than that, and Goldberg couldn't really, you know, kick it. And that was the unfortunate part. But he was good as a spectacle wrestler. You know, the spear, the jackhammer, squash match, pin, this great winning streak. Like, all right, that was cool with it. But, you know, he was never this great wrestler. And now that he's so unwilling to put people over as well in his later years, as that's been well documented, if Goldberg was coming, the only fight I would want to see is him and Riddle. Since that's a real beef, I think that would be entertaining.
Yeah, but he's not. So
I have no desire to see Goldberg come back at this point. And especially to take the belt from Roman, that would be terrible if that was the case.
It'd only be good if you saw Goldberg open up the show and beat somebody in a minute. Otherwise, you're going to have Roman beat him in a minute.
Roman, the two of them having a you know, knockdown, drag-out fight, that would be terrible.
That's not
and then
happen.
Having Roman only compete in a three-minute match at WrestleMania, that's a waste.
Yeah, Roman's going
to
beat Goldberg.
So this whole thing is a waste, and Vince just wants to have the match that they didn't get to have last year. It was advertised, and it never happened.
Wait a minute. Doesn't The Miz have the Money in the Bank?
Yes.
Okay. Goldberg versus Roman is the match. Roman beats Goldberg in 3 minutes or less. Like, he just beats him quickly. Now, then out of nowhere, somebody comes running out of the crowd, or there is no crowd, coming running from behind.
Well, there might be. There might be a crowd.
Okay.
It might be a very limited crowd, but there might be a crowd. They don't know yet. So that was the part of the discussions going back and forth, because The Rock didn't want to do it in front of no fans, but there might be fans in Florida. They're not sure yet. It depends, obviously, on the vaccine and whatnot. And because they're not doing it in L.A., Vince really doesn't want to do it. So that's that.
So the Johnny Nitro, John Morrison.
Morrison, yeah.
Jumps in the ring after Roman is celebrating his victory of Goldberg in a minute or 2 minutes at WrestleMania. He low blows Roman Reigns. Low blows Reigns, then hits him in the back of the head with a fucking chair. Knocks him out. Just bashes him with a chair. Now the Usos come running down, and they chase John Morrison off. And they run after him, or one of those, or both of the Usos, or whatever, and they're running after him. Then they chase him away. Roman's down. They're chasing after Morrison. Now the Miz comes out with the Money in the Bank, cashes in the Money in the Bank. Fucking skull crushing finale. Here it comes. And then Roman shoves him. He goes off the ropes, and Roman Superman punches him in the face, fucking covers him and beats him. And now, or they have a match, or then they have a match that lasts a while. Like, so then Roman and The Miz
So, like, the Miz hits the skull-crushing finale, Roman kicks out, and they actually have a match from there?
Right, and then Roman
if they had a full-fledged good match and ended up being, you know, like, it saved the main event kind of idea, I'd be for it.
10 to 15 minutes, whatever it is. 10 minutes?
Yeah.
10-minute match. So, you know, you get the whole spectacle of out comes Goldberg, out comes Roman. Roman beats Goldberg in a minute, putting over Roman big time. Here comes the fucking attack from John Morrison. Then the Usos chase him away, so that explains why now they're distracted, leaving Roman alone. Here comes The Miz with the Money in the Bank. Skull-crushing finale. Doesn't do it. He's flipping out on the referee. He covers him again. Roman kicks out. He picks him up, goes to do another one. He counters it. Then they get into a match. Then they do a 10-minute match, and maybe Roman wins. And then Roman keeps the title and whatever the fuck. But at
least now there's no more briefcase. I'd be fine with that. But the thing is, I can absolutely see Roman losing to Goldberg because Roman's the heel, Goldberg's the face, and Vince, Goldberg doesn't like to put people over anyways. We mentioned this before. Goldberg kind of went into business for himself a little bit, saying, you know, Roman's next on the bump. They're building to this. It's a backup already. But it kills me to say it. I could see Vince wanting that happy moment of, oh, Goldberg, the superhero, the one kids look up to. He's the one to topple Roman Reigns.
Man, you know, if you were going to do it, though, wouldn't you do it with Daniel Bryan, giving him the knee kick to the head and winning the title from Roman? And
they don't care about Daniel, though. They never have. They never looked at him in that way.
Good God.
Sadly, I know. There's so I just hate the idea of we've had this amazing Roman run. I mean, it has been stellar, top-notch, better than what we thought we would have gotten from Roman. I've really enjoyed it.
That is 4 months to 5 months from now, so.
Exactly. Plans could change and all that stuff. So, any event, continuing with the WrestleVote stuff, back on track here. As far as the other two matches go, the non-Goldberg one, that's the only one that seems like it's got something legitimate to it, definitely. Now, we mentioned last year at this time that Edge and Orton might be a possibility because they thought about making Edge the champion. So that's another one that's a very obvious, you know, prediction to make. That's not something that takes rocket science to say is a possibility for WrestleMania. And because we know Edge will have a match at Mania. It's already been stated. He's unfortunately got injured and since then hasn't been able to return, but he was supposed to have other matches already. Was supposed to do something at SummerSlam. That didn't happen. Okay. But this McIntyre, Lesnar, Keith Lee thing, the thing right now is already these matches have been denied. You know, there's a bunch of people that have chimed in saying that these were never pitched. These matches have not even been described as happening, especially the Brock, Drew, Keith Lee thing. And it hasn't been pitched. No, the TLC card is not even finalized yet, never mind the Royal Rumble.
Right.
And apparently Vince is very behind on the Rumble planning as well. He's struggling to nail down plans. There's been a lot of back and forth in the back, and a lot of the top leadership is coming from Bruce Pritchard, and people are not happy with his creative decisions. So there's a lot of, you know, disgruntled employees, basically.
You know what they should have done? They should have put Edge on SmackDown, given Edge the Money in the Bank briefcase, and at WrestleMania or the night after WrestleMania, Edge cashes in on Roman and spears him and fucking beats him.
Oh, yeah. Think about it.
That would have been big.
That's a mark-out moment, no doubt about it. You came up with that in 10 seconds. Now let's write our way to have that happen. It's simple. There's so many ways you can do it and make it entertaining. And, or have Edge, you know, I don't want to see him win the Rumble, but that's always an option too. I wouldn't want to see, I like the Rumble putting over people. Right now the rumor for the Rumble is that Rhea Ripley is going to be the one to win and Big E. But I have a hard time believing that they're going to give Big E the Rumble win here.
Right.
I just don't see it happening. I would love it if they did. I mean, he's finally got new theme music. He's coming out with the 5-count chalk in his hands again. I like the transition on SmackDown, but I just don't foresee him winning the Rumble at this point.
They have shown a couple times that they're flirting with pushing him. They've shown it a couple times. They've pushed him a couple times, which does show you they're thinking about something.
They're thinking about it, but then they cool off in their typical 3-week fashion.
Yeah.
So those matches were clearly, you know, not discussed, not going to happen. But the biggest thing I want to get into here is
otherwise Roman's going to win. Roman's just got a 90% Roman's got to win unless you have a face. That's going to be exciting to beat.
Yeah, unless they build up a great face a la Daniel Bryan or someone like that in time, there's no reason to have a Goldberg take the title.
Right.
That killed me when he beat The Fiend. And it's not even just because I like The Fiend. It was just a terribly booked idea. There was no reason to have a transitional championship champion at that point in time. They did it just for the Saudi crowd, and it was disgusting.
That was... Dude,
so
I can't even believe that that's real. I didn't even remember that because it's so fucking asinine.
Yeah, and it was only February of this year, you know?
Oh, my God.
So the thing with Lesnar is he's a smart businessman. Love him or hate him, you know, I've never been a big fan of Lesnar, but I've always respected
he's
the fact
a mercenary.
That he gets the money. He gets the goddamn money. And he's always been able to, you know, procure these gigantic bags from Vince more than anybody else has been able to demand. And I say demand clearly there. He's, you know, and anytime is the money is right, Lesnar shows up. We know that. Yep. So I highly believe that AEW would consider making a viable offer. Now, can they afford Lesnar? Do they even buy? I don't know. You know, it depends. But I can see a bidding war, and a lot of people have been guessing at this, between the two major companies, between AEW and WWE. And I can picture him doing what Orton did, trying to bump up his contract price. I mean, WWE basically didn't want to pay him right now for just not appearing, so they let his contract go. But it wasn't under bad terms or anything. And I could see him in either company if the money's right. I could picture him walking out at Daly's place just as much as he comes back to the, you know, the Thunderdome.
Yeah, I think
It just matters of who signs more on the dotted line.
He just reminds me of CM Punk, I feel like, where he would only do stuff for money.
Yes, and WWE needs him still at this point, sadly, because he's one of the biggest names and draws that they had access to.
Well, the thing is, and the losing draws, him is the draw amounts are getting way less than they were.
Oh, it's still way less, but we're at the point now where if you're drawing 10,000, it's beneficial.
Oh my God.
Joe Cronin, you're blocked. My name's Road Dog, do you like my cock? Joe Cronin, you're blocked. My name's Road Dog, do you like my cock?
Oh my God.
You're gonna like it a lot. My name's Road Dog, do you like my cock?
Hard to take Miro seriously when he looks like a jacked-up version of the Kerwin White character.
The game! Holy shit, the game just dropped $32. The $32 Road Dog blocked me donation again. Wow, man, thank you. Yeah, he looks like a fucking garbage pail.
He's not wrong.
He looks like a garbage pail kid on crack. He looks like Dennis Rodman's closet was raided. He's wearing $300 shirts. He's a douchebag. The game.
The game.
Thank you, game. Imagine that really was Triple H just donating to make fun of Miro because he hates him.
Hey, we said it before. We want to see Hunter finally going ahead and crashing on AEW's party, so I'd be all about it.
My friend, thank you for dropping that much money on me tonight. That was crazy. And on top of it, it hit the goal. You just hit the goal. Oh, almost. 99.46.
With the blocked Road Dog donation, we haven't heard in a while. So.
Hard to imagine. I drove around and lifted stuff and busted my ass for 4.5 hours today, and I made $28. Like, it's hard to believe. But we sat here and talked about how the fucking wrestlers. So thank you, man, for that donation. What else you got? Let me quickly just plug the Botch Club thing. Let's see what Botch Club was talking about. Play this, they said, and let's see what it is. It's Vince McMahon. On his wheelchair back in the day.
Oh boy,
I remember this.
Off the street, got to be handy with the steel if you know what I mean. Earn your keep.
Oh my God. Mount
up. It was a clear black night, a clear white moon. Warmer G was on the streets trying to consume some search for the E, so I could get.
You can't be any deep off the street.
That's fire, bro. I think he meant me for me to watch this though. Oh, my God.
He
he's going to go. He picked it up.
Hogan slamming Zeus back in the day. I'm afraid to show that one. For some reason, the wrestling match clips, I don't know why, they do worse.
Yeah.
I'm afraid to show that one. But Botch Club, go check them out on Instagram. They have so many botches and so much crazy stuff. And TikTok. Thousands of viewers. Wrestlers follow them and comment down. They get in fights in the comments with people. It's amazing. So go sub to Botch Club on Instagram or follow them, whatever it's called on Instagram. Man,
tomorrow night will be the first SmackDown in the new Thunderdome at Tropicana Field, and they had to move their COVID-19 testing facility towards the localized to St. Pete's section so they can go ahead and this will now make the drive, you know, well over almost close to an hour. It's like an hour and a half drive, they said, between Orlando and St. Pete. And it adds more time. So this is unfortunate for them to have to go ahead and drive so far to get tested before, you know, it's things they need to have a negative test before they can be part of the active roster anyways. But it's really just a hindrance. So they're trying to change some routines at this time while still being safe. But while Triple H was doing all of his media stuff, he was talking to Sports Business Journal, and he said the number one thing that he looks to in particular that can even outweigh experience in the right circumstance when hiring new wrestlers is charisma. He said, for us, charisma is king. I'm looking for that person, male or female, that walks into a room and you're drawn to them, that just has that charisma factor. But the funny thing is that we get less charisma, I feel like, on NXT than anything. They have great match quality all the time, but we just don't get the characters as we do elsewhere, unfortunately. So,
yeah, I think that
I wish that they can convey that better themselves.
Why the
also
fuck?
Firing through the news? Kevin Owens says he wants to be tag team champions.
Why the fuck is
Spez?
What the fuck is going on, man? Why is Spez Phoenix blocked again?
Really? Gotta love the chat going wild.
No, but why the fuck does he keep getting blocked? Like, he's blocked.
Give it a hell yeah!
One more, Joe. Just uploaded Snoop Dogg response to WWE mad about him showing up on AEW. Must watch.
That's pretty funny. I gotta check that out.
But after seeing their intense rivalry throughout ROH and then NXT and also the main roster, I would love to see them work together. You know, we've seen them be friends briefly, but never in a lengthy situation in WWE TV. So for them two to go after a tag team title, I think that would be excellent. Sammy could you know, they could work heel or face. I prefer them both to be heels. Turn Kevin heel again and let them go ahead and have a great program and go after the tag titles, because they have such, you know, chemistry together. I feel like this could be something special, something a lot of fun, you know, a lot of fun to be had with these two. I don't know if you're for it or not, but I would certainly like to have those two as tag champs.
I'm not even listening to what you're saying, to be honest.
That's all right. According to Fightful Select, there's a lot of plans for the NXT creative team.
Flip the fuck out.
They wanted to go ahead and have Charlotte Flair do a ton of things before and after capturing the NXT title, and it actually came down to the Raw side of things saying no, they're not letting them. They basically nixed every single idea that NXT had. That's why, besides the coronavirus happening and the pandemic, there was no real payoff to Charlotte getting the NXT title. She didn't put anyone over, and she didn't get pinned, you know, either. So it ended up being this triple threat to get the belt off of her, and then not long after, she disappeared to have surgery. So unfortunately, you know, Triple H kept saying, oh, it'll make sense eventually, and then later on he just kind of gave up on that point and said, well, COVID changed plans, so it's not going to make sense. But I mean, they wanted to have a big push with NXT with adding Bianca Belair. It was supposed to be a triple threat match between Flair, Rhea Ripley, and Bianca Belair at WrestleMania. That would have been excellent. I wish that happened. But unfortunately, we didn't get that either because of the Raw creative team. It is confirmed Candice LeRae, her arm is broken, definitely. There's no estimate on how long it'll take her to return to the ring. But thankfully, she can still participate in the meantime. So they can do the Gargano Way promos, and she'll still be on screen in the interim. She didn't need surgery, thankfully, and it'll heal hopefully in a few weeks' time. So we're hoping it won't be that long of a delay.
That's
tomorrow
good.
Night for SmackDown. The company did announce that Dolph Ziggler will face half of the SmackDown Tag Team Champions this week. So he'll take on Montez Ford. And then Sami Zayn is going to take on Big E in a non-title match. Mm. And then Big E versus Sami Zayn is also being thought about for TLC. So we might see Big E get a chance to become the IC champion at TLC.
See, I would like that.
That's good news.
Get him the IC belt would be good.
That's a great way to kick him off. I just think it's too soon to have him win the Rumble. Let him get a run with the IC title for a while. Let him be successful as a single star. He's been with the New Day for, 5 years at this point? Give us a chance to know him as a singles wrestler. Having him and Sami Zayn having a series together, sign me up. I'm all about that. They're both great workers. And then we're also going to see Sasha Banks and Carmella have their contract signing for the TLC SmackDown Women's title match. So that'll be made official. And then we're also going to be seeing Billie Kay, she's trying to find a partner to face the Riot Squad. So some people think that it might be Eva Marie. Other people think that it could be, are they going to bring back Peyton Royce? We don't really know yet what they have in store for us. So that's kind of something to look forward to as well. Silly that they broke up the Iconics to put them back in a tag team anyways.
Either put them back together or let Peyton Royce do her singles push. I don't get what else they would do.
Yeah, hopefully Peyton does get the chance. Billie Kay needs to be in a tag team at this time, but I also mentioned that Joey Ryan has filed multiple extensions on all of his lawsuits against his accusers. They all made allegations against him as part of the Speaking Out movement. And on December 7th, all of his cases were reviewed by Judge Michael Fitzgerald, and he issued a warning stating that the cases will be dismissed due to lack of prosecution. So there's not enough for them to prosecute, So
wow.
Joey Ryan has until December 23rd to respond to this order, or his case will be dismissed on the 28th. So some of the issues they had is serving the plaintiffs. They haven't been able to serve the people that they're suing. And then they had issues with the address provided for some of them as well. So that's why they said that they were held up on some of it. But it's a $10 million lawsuit that he also has with Impact Wrestling that he has for breach of contract going too. So all of these are getting extended at this time. But if he doesn't come out with more evidence by the 27th or the 23rd, then his case will be dismissed.
Well, that's going to go nowhere, it sounds like.
It seemed like that was the problem to begin with. And I was contemplating bringing this up, but I haven't seen all the information yet. But from reading what I did look into so far, MJF's ex-girlfriend blasted him on social media.
Oh, wow. Here we go.
And it kind of tuned into, she said she had quit her job and moved everything to a new state where she didn't have family or friends. And it basically goes on where she kind of craps on him after a while. And it just, some of it's not bad, but
he's probably going to think, nice. That's going to help my character.
But she goes on, she apologized and she's like, I had appointments and bookings centered around living there, and the rug got pulled underneath my feet. I acted out. I apologize. It's part of it is like her going ahead and moving on. And so, I mean, some of it could be good. Thankfully, I don't know.
Sounds like her just complaining about oh man.
Part of it is a complaint. Part of it is her trying to grow as a person. Part of it is, coming against him because she went homeless for a bit after they broke up. So it kind of they had a terrible breakup, and her blasting him is like trying to paint him in a bad light in that sense. But
that's her growing up is complaining about all this shit.
Her apologizing for her actions in this gigantic message is what she's trying to be held accountable for by herself.
What did she do?
She said, about the way she acted, nothing I said that has been true, but it doesn't mean that it needs to be said to the general public. I was unprofessional. Someone who cared deeply about their image and perception in the locker room shouldn't have to worry about their real life in the public eye, and I'm sorry. So that's her basically apologizing for saying the things she said
I was better than you, and you know it. That's all you needed.
That's all you needed. And then last but not least, why Pac disappeared from AEW? As we said, we were already on top of this a few weeks back. We said he wouldn't be featured for a few weeks because of the holidays and travel. So we knew that that would be an issue. But now plans are kind of being forced to change again because Penta injured his leg on Wednesday's Dynamite show. Well, technically last week's tape show. And now we're unsure as to what's going to happen with the Death Triangle team. But they still have plans to utilize Pac once 2021 arrives. And according to Tony Khan, it's going to be a very big year for Pac. So that's a good thing.
Well, sure. I'm bored as hell by him, but that's me.
I like his matches. So, you know, usually he looks intense, and I like the way he wrestles. So,
yeah, I kind of like the way he wrestles, but I don't know, man.
Yeah, the injury on that we saw on Dynamite wasn't the actual injury because Penta had injured his leg a few weeks back while training,
yeah,
and he re-aggravated it. So they used that the timekeeper table spot to get him out of the whole match, which is a smart way to, you know, still have him be in the advertised match but not have him compete the entire time.
Real quick, I got to take a shot at Impact here. Apparently 750,000 people.
Yeah, all together. They're counting digital, replay, you know, all of it, I guess. So that's not just a live. Because live, I forget what we said they got. We said the other night it was like 250,000,
so
I believe.
So on television, they got 250,000 views.
Yes.
But
counting in Twitch, the YouTube rebroadcast, wherever they play, they it's on a bunch of things.
So then they're taking their YouTube, Twitch, and every other number and adding
it
together.
Yeah, they counted all of their media playback for that one episode.
So I just want to congratulate Donald Trump on this wonderful tweet. Here it is. Impact on Access TV drew more than... No, it says Impact on Access TV drew more than 750,000 fans to Access TV and digital platforms.
Yeah, and digital platforms.
Yeah, no, you drew 250,000 fans on Access TV. But I like the wording, Trump. I said Donald Trump is running Impact's Twitter. Impact on Access TV drew more than 750,000 fans. Like, what a weird tweet. How fucking paranoid are you guys over there?
They had on Access 221,000 exactly with a 0.08 rating under 50 demo.
Yeah.
They came in 96th overall.
Yeah. So they're telling me that what?
And 50,000 on Twitch, which broke a record there.
So 500,000 people watch them on YouTube and Twitch?
Between rebroadcast, on demand, all of it all together, yeah.
Well, let's go look at those numbers then.
I don't know how to get their on demand numbers, but
let's see. Impact Wrestling.
Like Access TV, they're counting, because I read the whole detail before, and for all of it, it was all their digital breakdown, so.
What exactly are they counting? On YouTube, they don't broadcast their show. They only broadcast clips.
Yeah, they did this week. They had it at 10 p.m. As soon as it went off on Twitch, it went live on YouTube.
Where is that?
Super Jack.
Here it is.
Triple Mania Saturday, Omega defends his Triple A title.
Triple Mania. Yeah, Omega's the champion over there. I forgot about that, too. Thank you. Was that Triple M or Omega or something?
Yeah, the full episode had 279,000 views on it.
Well, they did get it.
Appearance, you know, just the ending in its own upload had 356,000 views.
Well, so, okay. I mean, they got it if they count all the views.
And Sting's debut didn't, you know, well over a million. It was trending worldwide. So they're, you know, Impact and AEW are both happy with the last 2 weeks, certainly.
Oh, yeah. Look at everybody in this thumbnail. They're all happy. Sammy Callahan looks like he's getting raped in his ass. Look at him. And then whoever that is on the left, is that Rich Swann? He looks like he's the one doing it.
Yeah.
Very homoerotic there. So yeah, I guess they did get 750,000 if you add up all the numbers on all their social media platforms and their TV rating. Wow. Good God. Well, Alex Oley, thanks for the $2, man. What's up, brother? And by the way, we hit the goal, so thank you guys for that, too. It's pretty funny that AEW basically redid the whole segment because they knew nobody watched. Tony Khan is probably second-guessing this right now. I love Callis, but Impact is a liability. I don't think they're a liability as long as you don't get involved in them anymore. You know, just
apparently this was really all they had planned. It was just to go there, say this, and then do it again the next night, just because you knew a lot of people weren't going to watch it, but they knew their dedicated following would show up. So that really means about 150,000 AEW viewers watch Impact every week, and then about 50 or 60,000 went over to watch Kenny Omega.
But about, I would say, and remember, replayability is counted, so I would guess that maybe about 150,000 other wrestling fans tuned into them on YouTube, and probably like 50,000 tuned into them on Twitch. And those are the real numbers of those, which are pretty decent. Yeah. But
and that's 300,000. That's double what they got the week before.
Yeah. And they won't get it again. That. I mean, Impact was better than Raw. I mean, Impact Wrestling.
I only watched the Kenny thing. I can't go back to Impact. I can't torture myself.
Impact. I hate them all. I hope Josh Matthews falls down a flight of stairs. But
I can't stand his commentary.
Oh, my God. Daniel Bryan, or however he talks.
Last thing I did forget to mention, I'm sorry, because I said, as you know, they're changing plans with Pac, and they're not sure what's going to happen.
Crazy also, Steve.
Ray Phoenix, he hit his head really bad on the floor in that spot as well after and the six-man tag match, and he's okay. He got rocked, he said, but he's okay. So thankfully, you know, no real issue, and he's not injured going forward. Thankfully.
Fuck yeah. Fuck yeah, Phoenix.
But it was a hell of a bump he took. He dives on the outside to hit Eddie, and as soon as Eddie tries to catch him, but he lands a little bit short, and it looks like he power bombs him down with the way he falls, and he goes right in the back of his head. So
that's terrible. I'm glad he's okay.
Yeah, I didn't like his outfit, and I wasn't a big fan of his promo either, the Mr. Gentleman promo.
Right. Type.
Allow me to introduce myself. Are you gonna fuck the guy?
Ladies and gentlemen, it is 1:13 in the morning. I had a super long day. Jake had a long day. My voice isn't working anymore for this show tonight. I have worn it out. I really hope you guys check out Botch Club, and I really hope you guys check out my Patreon on patreon.com/JoeCroninShow. Become a $5 patron. Become a $10 patron. Do something. Give me your money. Thank you to Chris J, who became a $10 patron. 30 hours of bonus content a month coming. We have a new episode of Off the Rails with Jesse and Drew. A new episode of After Dark coming with me and Jesse this week. Plus, me and Jake did a 1 hour and 20 minute show the other day. That's available also.
Yeah, that's a hell of a listen. Definitely check that out. A lot of topics we covered.
We did a bunch of shit to people that shouldn't be done to anybody. We did a lot of anal probing on that show. Plus, this Saturday, the Corrupted Podcast is back on Patreon. Corrupted, live at 1 a.m. on Patreon. You guys can either download the podcast every weekend when it comes out, or if you're a patron, you can actually listen to it live as we do it Saturday night, which is technically Sunday morning, but you know what I mean. So come hang out for that. We usually have at least 60 people watching live, amazingly, at 1 a.m., which is crazy. For Corrupted Podcast, and more is coming as well. So just check out Patreon. There's a ton of shows not on YouTube, plus it supports the channel. And speaking of support, you guys really supported right there. I had a goal tonight, a pretty steep goal, and you guys smashed it, $2 over. Thank you for that, you sick bastards. I'm sick, sorry that I'm a little bit weird because of that. Shout out to JD Venom. He is the king of the wheel. And tomorrow night, JD Venom puts his crown on the line on Monetize This, episode 294, I believe. It could be 295, but I think it's 294 tomorrow night. And that's going to be big, man, because we're on the road to 300 episodes of Monetize This, and the belt goes on the line on episode 300. But right now, the crown's on the line. JD Venom is the king of Monetize This, king of the Joe Crohn Show. JD Venom in OG, big penis, you know him. And tomorrow night, he puts his crown on the line on Monetize This. So make sure you guys are watching tomorrow night, whether it's on Corrupted Nation, my other channel, or right here on Joe Crohn Show. Monetize This. Tomorrow night, the party starts, and we evaluate my throat cancer. It's going to be a lot of fun. Thanks to Alex Oley for that last dono. Rest in peace to Tommy. Bless his heart. I think I'm going to watch The Fifth Element tonight and have a drink in honor of Zeus. I love him. I love him. And good to see Sting back too. And coming up on Patreon, the post shows of Monetize This. Once we edit out everything that needs to be edited out.
Yeah, that and Throwdown. Gonna need some
hello,
work.
Hello, folks. Oh, you freaking...
Thank you, everybody. I don't think Tommy was here saying hi today. I don't think so. Unless somebody saw him for real. If he did, he messaged me once on Facebook, and then I messaged him a couple times. He never responded to me, which is weird. So if he was in here saying hi, I'm definitely going to block him. Because what kind of person doesn't talk to you in real life multiple times?
I don't think that was him.
Okay. Yeah, he'd have a check mark if it was him. You're welcome for that check mark, too, you little fucking rat bastard piece of shit. See you guys tomorrow.
What have you got to show in your fucking DMs? Your fucking DMs. What do you got to show?
Oh, he really was? I'm going to block him. I'm going to block him, then. What kind of piece of shit?
It was him? Ah, look at that.
Dude, what kind of piece of shit never responds to me on Facebook for weeks? And even
look at that.
And even the other day, I said hi to him, and he didn't say anything back. Then he comes in my chat and just goes, hey, everybody, ha ha. But then he says, you're all scumbags, so why would he come in the chat?
He goes off on the chat constantly.
Why would he come in the chat and say hi to everybody if he calls the audience all scumbags?
I just assumed it wasn't him. Look at that.
Wow, I mean, you know, you're all your trolls and your scumbag audience, Joe. You're a scumbag audience. All Joe's fans are just fucking trolls. Like, I mean, but then you come in the chat to say hi? Fuck are you doing? Christmas spirit? Fuck him. I hope he fucking keels over on Christmas.
Yeah, that's the Christmas spirit.
Motherfucking piece of shit. That's fucked up. I'm sorry.
Yeah, you don't want him to die. Maybe just the sex crimes division will catch up with him.
That's fucked up. I shouldn't have said that. I'll probably die. I probably have throat cancer. The great irony of that would be delicious. I'm telling you, man, if I ended up with a tube in my face and I was like Bobby Heenan and I was like, and I was doing that, just please kill me. I won't even be here. Just end me. Like, I gotta change my fucking diapers while my kids, like, run around on top of me telling me all this stuff and I can't say anything back to them. They're like, look what we did today. And I'm like, oh. No, fuck that. What? I'm Joe. Why you just messaged me and called me somebody else? The fuck?
Leave it to Rwandi.
I could do my own sign language. Call people perros. Alright, I'm out of here. Good night, everybody. Thanks for being here out of nowhere.
It's time to kill people. Sting. Zeus. AEW. Cody Rhodes' cock.
Do your
fucking job.
If you guys know anybody that's a funny person, a comedian, or a good podcaster, have them email me, baby. We need some new co-host blood on the Joe Cronin Show. So please, have them hit me up. Love to try them out, put them on the shows, talk to them, and let them know, man, that Joe Cronin's looking for their cock. Here's a little bit of Bullfrog from the other night. It was a lot of fun. One thing that's helped every time is zinc. When I've been sucking on a zinc lozenge or whatever the hell you call it, it feels a lot better. Like for a little while afterwards, it's weird, man.
You know what will help? A real good trick.
Come, your cum.
Yes. Chips, salty chips.
I'm eating salty chips right now.
Yeah, that helps. The salt on the chips actually helps.
Yeah, salty Cameron's dick chips. I bought them from the local store up the street.
Or pretzels.
Where are you getting these sound clips from?
You like that? I taped Bullfrog the other night, and I got every mannerism and noise that he's ever made. Listen to this one where it sounds like he's choking. Hold on, let me play it. Isn't that funny, man? Like, he's fucking choking in that clip. That's crazy. Now, listen to this one. I've got one where he comes. Look at this. Yeah,
you've been putting in the overtime.
Now listen to this one. This is one where he says, "I'll kill JB." This is crazy that he says this. Listen to this, ready?
I'll kill JB.
Yeah, he did that. He does that on the show.
Was he like?
He does it on
someone
the show.
Pinching his nuts in that one?
Yeah. Well, no, he made a bunch of noises and then he did that, and I go, "Wait a second, that's not just a noise." I think he said, "I'll kill JB," and then let me play it again. Hold on so you can hear it again. Ready? Watch this.
Would he send it by pigeon?
Oh, kill JB!
Well, you got two different ones.
Yeah, it's like the second one. He did it twice. The second one is what gave it away.
Give me a hell yeah live chat for Joe No Corona Cronin for a speedy recovery. Also, Joe, I'm sure your weirdo sidekick on this show will have something to say about my donation. Miserable fuck. More donations to come tonight.
Oh, my God.
The Wrestle Daily Botch Club.
The Botch Club, thank you, brother. Follow them on Instagram. They are supporting the show. I don't remember who complains about Botch Club usually.
Oh, I think he's talking about me because I give him shit.
Oh, is it you?
Like, here comes another copyright.
Oh, you are a weirdo fuck, so you got the right guy. Okay, yeah. But, you know.
For a minute, I thought it was me. You know, I'm like, hey.
Well, no, yeah, if he had said, well,
no,
here's one.
Sure it was true.
Yeah, he said complains.
Well, then he said miserable fuck, and I'm like, well.
Yeah, miserable, miserable fuck who complains somehow wasn't about you.
I wonder what he would say if he ever found out that I was the Bitch Club donator. Oh,
the hell?
Oops!
Oh my God!
I just heard Bitch Club and saw you. Just
he'd probably laugh and be like,
"You had like the VIP section at some lounge, the Bitch Club."
Yeah.
Hey, he pays for advertising. That means he pays for roasting, too.
Listen to this. I have another one where Bullfrog, like, it sounds like he comes into the moonlight. Listen to this. Ready? Listen to this.
Oh, Jesus.
Oh!
Oh, I hope the whole fucking thing eclipses.
Oh,
well,
my God.
I guess it would, right? He steps in front of it, howls at it.
Yeah.
Eclipse.
I mean, listen.
Do you have that clip
time.
Of where he blew his brains out?
No, but I do have one where he's freaking out about wanting to, basically he wants to die. He's sick of Christmas and he wants it to be over with.
He needs a special trigger.
Yeah, yeah.
Custom made.
Listen to this. It sounds like he's at the end of his wits with life. Larry, I'm going to play this. Listen to this. This is sad right here. Oh, jeez. God. He had COVID.
Hell yeah.
He had COVID, bro.
Wow.
Now,
it was just part of his food that he didn't swallow all the way.
I got one more to play you, and then we'll move on. But one more. This one is where you like. It's like he's begging to come. He goes, come, 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 come. Please let me come. And he's like begging to come. Oh. It's very weird. Listen to this, right?
I'll beg him to go.
Here you go.
Just go.
Come for me, Joe. Please come for me now. Please come, Joe. Daddy Joe, please come. Oh,
oh my God.
Wow. That one was crystal clear, too. You clipped that?
Yeah, I clipped it. I clipped that. I took these great clips from him the other day.
Great abominations. My Lord.
Yeah, when you were talking a minute ago, I also heard one. I don't know if you accidentally hit the button or not, but it sounded like the Enterprise at Impulse Power, but I think it was just him like grunting or something.
Yeah, I think it was just him grunting. I agree. Ugh. Unbelievable, though.
It was like a vacuum getting stuck, and then and just... I don't know what the fuck. He made some... it was like his vocal cords turned into this crushed can of a...
And you just said it like
I call random YouTube shows and shit that are way outside of this community.
Senator!
All right. I did not mean to play that. Right. That was Bullfrog.
That
sounded like it. That was his safe word, and somebody was twisting his nipples too.
Listen,
hard.
Yeah. Listen to this.
Oh, no. It's the holidays, Joe. Come on.
I mean, so here's the clip where he says, I'll beat my own knees. Let me play it.
Joe. This was after his knee surgery, right?
I don't know why.
His knees.
Yeah, he doesn't say that. He says, I'm going to beat my knees with my hands because he's mad at his kneecaps. Let me play it again. Hold on, let me play it.
I want to beat my fucking knees!
Well, that's actually funny
because it's out of context. It's not even out of context, but it's out of context. You know what I mean? Like, that is some unique shit right there.
Oh my God.
That's some funny, unique shit.
And he talks about fucking his elbows. He talks about wanting to fuck his wrist. Listen to this one where he screams that he wants...
What?
Listen to this one where he says he really wants to fuck his wrist. Listen to this.
I want to get froggy with my wrist. I want to fucking ejaculate my wrist.
You know what that is? That's confirmation that getting froggy is equivalent to fucking. Someone's got to be taking notes on this.
What the fuck is that?
So like when he takes a razor blade.
What the fuck is going on?
All right, listen. this is another clip. He goes through every body part, his neck, his feet. Now this is
he
where
goes
he says
every fucking body part.
This one is where he says he's going to come all over his knees. He's going to come on his knees. Listen to this.
I would come over my knees, my neck. My neck, my back.
Oh my God.
I would come over my balls.
Here's where he says, I'm going to cover my knees with... He's gonna cover both his knees with his cum. Listen to this.
I want to cover my knees with my cum. All over, spread it nice and juicy wide.
I wonder how that's going to work out with CPS.
Imagine how that statement's going to work out in the court. How is that statement going to work in the court, boys?
Oh, my God. Oh, wow.
I even said that.
He just takes the gavel and shows them where he inserted it.
Oh, my God. I'm going to fucking die.
You're going to come in.
Where the fuck did these come from? I never even heard this.
I mean,
shit.
I really clipped a lot of this stuff the other night. It was all done out of, like, thin air almost.
Did you have to pay extra for the memory on this soundboard? That's a lot of clips.
Yeah, really linking all these clips together are very...
Clip it up in your ass!
Oh, yeah, like that one? Oh, my God. Okay, one last one, we'll move back onto the alien talk. Listen, here's the one where he says that he's going to rape... He wants Leah to rape him. It's very strange. Listen to this.
Leah, I want you to get down and nasty with the bullfrog.
Well, you can't even make that clip up, can you? Like, there was no mistakes made there. I mean, he was serious.
He didn't mince words, did he?
Penetrate the bullfrog, Leah!
Oh, man.
Yeah, that really wasn't taken into context at all, was it?
Very strange.
The frog wants a filching and a picking.
I mean, there's clips that are context, people. Then there's clips that are in context, aren't there?
Yeah, and you know, you got to give it to Botch Club, Botch Club with the 316 donation. I think they made all that possible. So Bullfrog's clips brought to you by Botch Club.
Shout out to Joe Cronin for plugging Botch Club, because I wouldn't have known about them until Joe Cronin did plug them out. I did go over and check their shit out on Instagram. Funny shit.
I got a picture of your mother on my phone. Picture that I keep in my home. A picture of Tommy and C. Mommy, I got a picture of your mom, Tommy. And I'm always jacking off on my knees. I wanna give her some of this. Tommy and C's mom. Pick a make me wanna freaking have to come. I gotta pick a Tommy and C's mom. I hang it up on my wall, and surely my pants will fall. Hang it on my wall, sure enough my pants will fall. I wanna jack it so bad to Tommy and C's mommy that I can't see clearly. Everything about my world is forgettable now. Yeah, Tommy's mom, biologically she might be a cow, but I kinda wanna let her nut go in that hole for show when I'm ready to explode. Tommy and C, your mama's looking fine to me. Like Debbie on a Saturday night, I wanna just slap that bird all night. Tommy and C, getting horny for your mommy, getting happy for your mommy. I'm getting hard for your mommy. Kind of crazy, Tommy, for your mommy. Oh, Tom, I want your mommy. Oh, Tom, I want your mommy. Tommy and C, I want your. Tommy and C, I want your mommy. My pee-pee's feeling kind of funny. Straight up on the Joe Cronin show. That's what I be talking about. Pimping moms left and right all night. And Tommy and C, your mama's looking fine to me.
Fucking wrist. Yo, yo, I tag your bitch in this. Tweeting in DMing me her big luscious tits. She getting ready for the dick. Hope your woman likes a dick. I'm gonna get that bitch some kids. Yeah, I'm drugged out and looking for fame. Singing in the rain. Little suicide, don't pray. Unless I pray on a woman's hole. Then my penis, it will grow.
I love weapons, and I love crack cocaine. If you want to, I can erase the pain. I love weapons, and I love crack cocaine. If you want to, I can show you how to erase the pain.
Every bridge, I did every drug. Still not enough for this filthy thug. I ain't happy till I run. through some slugs. Not satisfied till this carpet stained with blood. Give me all you own, or I'll burn your home. The purge is real, give me pearls, or I'll crack your dome. Off the fucking floor, fill it with foam. Soon you gonna learn what I'm on you, homes. This is America. In 2020, you fuck, you got no more luck. So suck it up and give me your truck, or I'll fuck you up. You better listen up.
America is.